It's You Know What Dude podcast on riotcast.com.
Yeah, we're back. What's up? This is definitely a fucking weird end. This is what I did. There's a weird vibe in the room. Usually there's a lot of energy to start the show because I have like 19 people on and it's like a bunch of regulars. I have one regular, Joe the Truth, and then I have two people. I literally forgot your names. I don't even fucking. I have no idea. Like, if you right now, you're like, wait, what's my. I'd be like, it's like a chick I banged in a parking lot. I have no idea who you are.
This is great because usually your ploy is Bobby will go, Chris, why don't you introduce everybody? Which is Bobby's way of saying, I have no idea who's sitting in front of me.
That is not true.
And now Scopo is not here.
That is not true all the time.
Right. But
99% of the time, that is absolutely true. But no, that's not why I do that. It's professional. It's called production value, Josephine.
What do you mean? Have a retard introduce everybody? I'm kidding, Chris. We live together. Put my toothbrush in your ass.
You don't live with Chris. You sleep at your girl's house. You're never home. I talk to him all the time. Him and the fucking new guy, whoever the fucking new guy is.
Mike Albanese.
Yeah, Mug, the fucking guy who makes soap.
His name's not Mug. He does make soap.
I know he does. That's why I said he makes soap.
He makes a beard cream. Business. Yeah, it comes in a bottle.
Yeah. Ooh. Well, he. Anyways, let's go around the room.
I still don't know who we are.
Yeah, I have no idea. I mean, you guys are very good-looking people. I say that.
Thank you.
That's true.
Thank you so much.
That's all that matters.
Great.
Well, to my right, we have Brendan Eyre.
Brendan Eyre, who I've never met, but I've heard lovely things.
Oh,
about.
Oh, thanks, man. This is great. Yeah. This is great. Thank you for having me.
And where are you from, bro?
I'm from Cleveland originally.
Oh, that shit place.
Yeah, I got it tattooed on my arm, which is a huge mistake. That if you want to. Get girls, just tattoo the shitty city.
Well, girl from Cleveland. From. I'm from Cleveland town. Yeah. What is the A for up at the? What is that?
That's just a error that everyone said. The guy just put a like a decoration, but everyone goes, does that say a Cleveland? And I go, no, I think that's just a flourish.
Wow.
But it looks like an A, right?
Yeah. Here's the thing: it's such beautiful work. And for him to fuck up on the top of that
is
terrible. I mean, that other tattoo is amazing. Show the camera that. What is that one? Not that one. That one's goofy. The one right there. That one's beautiful.
I got this one.
What is that?
It's kind of like a compass rose. I like old maps and shit.
Really?
Yeah, but I didn't realize. I got this, and I didn't realize every girl in Brooklyn has a compass rose on their inside of their
farm. I don't even know what a compass rose is.
It's like the little shit with northeast, southwest, and this kind of like a design.
That's how you know I'm not fucking anybody anymore. Yeah. I don't know the new tattoos on chicks' assholes.
Dude, you said you don't know what a compass rose is, and he explained what a compass is.
I know what a compass is. Yeah. I don't know what a compass rose.
I'm with you on that one. No, What's the rose portion?
So it's exactly what I said, Joe. If you'd maybe listen.
You described a compass.
No, that's a compass will tell you what direction it is. Uh-huh. On a map.
I see.
Those like pictures that show northeast, southwest, and the directions on like an old antique map.
Uh-huh.
That's a compass rose.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was just a compass.
No, I'm a compass you hold and it tells you where north is.
Right, in the woods with the magnet. Got it.
Yeah. You can use a needle.
Huh? What does that mean?
Yeah, and like a magnet, yeah. Right?
A needle. You can use your dick.
Hey.
On the board.
We got, stop fucking ruining everything with your knees.
You got long knees.
Joe, the Truth List is here again. Thank you so much for being here.
Sans t-shirt.
I almost
money.
Said thank you, God. That almost came. Sorry. You got, what did you say? You have a Sans t-shirt?
I said Sans t-shirt money. Sans means without.
Fuck. I'm going to get. You know what? What do you want? Here's the problem. Every time.
Come up with a question and then just put it out there.
Here's the problem. Every time I'm like, dude, I'll pay you right after the show. You leave.
He's got a heart out.
I do have a heart out tonight. And a heart on.
And that beautiful voice
is Luchana Gatica.
Luciana?
No, I.
Luciana.
I'm not Italian, yeah.
Luciana. So you're Spanish?
Yes.
What kind of Spanish are you, bub?
Chilean.
Isn't that where that chick from, the dude who killed the chick in Aruba got arrested?
That's Peru.
No, that's
Peru.
Yeah, you're being racist again.
Yeah, my. No, I said. Well, you can't really say that out of context, you fucking Puerto Rican. Well, the people who listen, it's like, now they think I'm being racist off air. They don't know why. All right, whatever. We'll get into that.
Also, you didn't say anything racist. You just said, I think I might be racist.
It was a callback to an earlier conversation.
Yeah. Well, I wasn't really. She wasn't really. All right, nice
he was right. Kidding.
Anyways,
we're all kidding.
We're all kidding.
We're all kidding. We love
people.
I'm racist, too. It's fine. That's why I'm here.
You can be racist, though, because you're one of them.
I know, exactly.
You're Chilean.
Exactly.
You live near pyramids. Do you have pyramids? Did you guys have Apocalypto people? Is it not?
I don't think so.
Well, where's Chile? Chile, right?
Yeah, it's that like the skinny country, right? Yeah. You know, South America.
Yeah.
I'll tell you right now, I'd be shocked if there wasn't a pyramid there.
There's pyramids. No, there's pyramids.
It goes without saying.
Yeah, you have pyramids.
There's mines. There are mines.
Mines?
Yeah, the miners, remember?
Oh, the miners. But you have pyramids. You have, like, Apocalypto shit there. Yeah,
probably from a pyramid scheme.
Wow, the show. I mean, it's my fault. I'm going to take the heat. Because I'm the one who says yeah to all. Like, yeah, that sounds good. I fucked up. This is when you need a Louis Gomez go, you guys all fucking suck. Everybody's a fucking dickhead. Suck my dick, fags.
Nobody needs Louis.
Yeah, no, but you're right, actually.
Including his son.
Oh, come on. Aww. Jesus Christ, dude.
Why is that so bad?
Because you have two women in the room, okay? Yeah. And I don't want them not to like me, so, aww.
Oh, I got you.
And the new guy that looks like a chubby little cutie. Tootie, he looks like somebody, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Very
I've
sexy.
I've been trying to figure it out
Thank
as
you.
Well.
Yeah. You look like somebody.
Thank
I don't
you.
Know who you are, but you look like somebody. We got Deepu in the house, the video master kid.
Yo.
Who's making everything right.
And VMK. Then
we got Big Box Lauren over here.
it's my box.
Yeah, it's a big box. We keep stuff in the box. And we're back. It's been a fucked up week for me.
Oh, boy.
Not a fucked up week. It's been a good week, but I've been fucking really, you know. The show's back on. I've been drumming every day, and it sucks. To learn an instrument in your 40s is retake. It's just fucking stupid. It's just the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. But fuck all my white people problems.
Don't say that. What is that? I hate that.
What, white
I
people
hate
problems?
White people problems.
Yeah, that's a legit problem. Do I have to learn an instrument? That's not like
a job.
Really hard.
Yeah, not to mention.
Are you white?
Yeah, but I get paid. No, not if you don't want me.
And
to.
You have problems. You're fat. That's a problem. You're aging.
Oh!
You know what I mean? You have a kid that you have to pay for. I didn't mean to say you're fat. I was trying to be funny.
No, that's the way. Listen, what is this show happen? What's happening?
Well, you fucking felt. You made me weird.
You put
and they're new.
Put
I don't
him
know.
In the head seat. You put him in the head seat.
I know. I should have put you in the side seat. You're better.
Yeah.
You're not better running things. You're not good in the Dan Soda seat. Oh, God, the show stinks.
Yeah, look at him, macho man. Yeah, look at him.
Where is he, from fucking New Orleans?
Look at his voices, right? I'm trying to fill in the boots or shoes, whatever he wears.
I love the idea that people are going to be like, hey, how was being on Bobby's podcast? I think it was pretty good. He just kept saying, thank God Joe listened to
me. I only said that once. Yeah. Then I said, it stinks.
Yeah.
You must have been thinking of the fans saying that.
Actually, this show, this last February, was its biggest month ever.
Wow.
And the biggest, most downloads ever of any show on Riotcast. And Riotcast itself is fucking off the charts this year. This last year was the biggest year we've ever had. I think it's over 10 million downloads.
Wow.
So congratulations to all the shows on Riotcast and to everybody who, all the fans who listen to this show. This show has been this month has been ridiculous. So
until now.
Kudos to everybody. Until now we go back to where we were in last year.
Lower
it was a
your
good
standards,
run.
Everybody.
It was a good run.
So anyways, enough about me.
We weren't even talking about you.
Well, I was talking about my week. I was gonna.
But you didn't even say anything.
I was talking about the show and drumming and now you know all
talk
the stuff
about, it.
About lines, learning lines, and it's weird. Like, have you ever been on? You've been on a show.
Yes.
You've been on a show, right?
Yeah.
You've been on a show, Joe.
A ton of shows.
What show have you been on? Like sitcom.
Oh, sitcom. No, I've been on sitcoms. What, you guys have been on sitcoms?
No, I was just one.
I was in a
yeah, you just
I was on a sketch show, but that was more improv.
No, I'm talking like television. Like
it was television. Yeah, yeah.
What is this assumption that everyone's been on sitcoms? Like 11 people have been on sitcoms.
Buddy, I was just saying it, so I didn't want to fucking assume that you weren't. That would be the dick move, too.
I know, you should have just
It was a lose-lose fucking situation.
You could have been like,
me.
Have you guys ever been on sitcoms? And then we would have all been like, no, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, but no.
We would have, not only have we not, you know we have.
Yeah, but I don't want
to. I've never gone out for a sitcom.
It doesn't have to be a sitcom. Like, you mean just a something
I
with
think
scripts,
I'm really
right?
attracted to you. I don't know what is going on. I don't know what you said. I don't know what you just said, but I love you, I think.
Thank
Listen,
you.
I'm sorry. And you too, dude.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, anyways.
Yes, shows.
I have a thing with me, okay? When I get anxiety, and when I get anxiety, which is the show and all the stuff going on and having to gear up for this. This is the first time I've ever done anything that went into a second season. You know, everything I've always done did one and done them out. You know what I mean? Yeah. And so this is, to come back to it, you have to beat all new PAs and the crew. And there's some people that are back. There's some, you know, these people you haven't seen for a year and you might have never saw again. Because you'll find out when you do these TV shows, they become your family. The makeup lady, the wardrobe lady, the PA, the AD, all these people, you're together in this fucking war, you know, working all day, month after month, trying to get this thing done. And all of a sudden, it's over. You have this big party. Everybody celebrates and tries to fuck each other. And then you don't see each other. You may never see each other again.
Yeah.
And, now, this is the first time I've ever come back where we all of a sudden you see each other and this big buildup in wardrobe, getting fittings and stuff you're going to wear and blah, blah, blah. And then, the cast, you see the cast again. These people are my friends. I love them all. Dennis, I saw Dennis for the first time since last summer.
Rodman?
No, Leary. Dennis Leary.
Oh, right. And, it's been a while. I haven't seen the show in a while.
And so it was like, when I get stressed out, when I get anxiety, I get fucking angry. I don't know where it's that fucking Boston thing. I snap easy.
Yeah,
you know
I do
mean?
That. That's normal, right?
I do that. I'm Latino.
Well, you hit your wife?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. No, I'm kidding. I fucking been snapping, and I go negative. I always fucking go negative, and I'm sitting there going, "What am I, stupid? Am I fucking nuts? I'm on a fucking show with Dennis Leary. It's fucking. I'm on the show." And I'm playing drums. I get to learn drums for free, basically. And all this I get all this amazing shit. And how the fuck dare I get stressed out? How the fuck dare I even get
too.
And negative?
And you look good.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, are you going to therapy? Are you seeing your
Well, I talked to my therapist today. I actually called my wife during therapy and apologized. I have a wife, Aww. But she'd let me cheat with you. I'm kidding. Just as long as you keep your mouth shut, nobody will know. But
it's okay. I'm into that.
Oh, cool. You Whoa. Whoa. Fucking guess Stavros is out. Guess who's my new opener? two ways.
I thought you were dating Stavros for a second. I was like, wow.
She would. I would.
Who is that?
Exactly.
He looks exactly like that.
He looks like me if I was a minion.
Oh.
Well, somebody.
Best guy, Stavros.
I guess I have kids and.
Best guy on Facebook.
He's
period.
The best.
He's the best. You ever
Can I look
the,
him up?
The
Can
naked
I request
pictures?
Him on
yeah,
Facebook?
Yeah, his Instagram is amazing.
Instagram
is
the
like,
best.
Who is
yeah.
this bitch?
So anyways, I called her up and I apologized.
What'd you apologize for?
Well, because I called her up and I fucking yelled at her about some shit. Somebody was sick. A family was sick.
A whole family?
Yeah, and then we went over there and then, this is what I don't fucking like. They were sick, and it's like, oh, we're fine. We were sick, but we're not contagious. Like, they went to med school, and they have, like, a fucking Petri dish, and they took their blood, and they look under a microscope and made an analysis,
right.
You know, and had their little things that spin, and, you know.
Oh, Bunsen burner.
Bunsen burners, right? That's not it, but.
Definitely not
fun.
It. Yeah.
Fun to say.
So then we find out that they're really sick, and they have some virus, and I'm like, we were there eating.
Was it herpes?
My kid was sucking on a microphone. A player, you know, it's like, what the fuck? You're jeopardizing everything. And I snapped. She's like, listen, you're not sick. Right now, we don't have to worry about it until you get sick. And she was really cool about it because she could be passive aggressive and make me snap. But she walked me down, but I still snapped. And I'm sick of being fucking angry.
Well, go to extra therapy.
Don't fucking tell me what to do, dude.
Sorry. But you know what? That's
I'm sorry, Joe. I'm hang on 1 second, you cocksucker. Joe, I'm sorry. Why do the lights keep flicking?
I don't know. I would yell at Deepu about it, though,
fucking
for sure.
Fucking goddamn Indian. Yeah.
That's not a crazy thing to be angry about. This family made you come to their house and insisted they weren't contagious.
They didn't make us come. But my wife made the judgment call.
But I think it's important to think, where am I at fault? I think that's important.
What do you mean?
That's what you're supposed to ask yourself.
What?
Where are you at fault?
I'm at
fault. How could you have done things better?
You just said.
I don't think he's at fault. What were they sick with?
What
kind of disease? You just said some virus.
It was a... It was
SARS?
Should I even be here right now? Are you sure you don't have it?
It was FICA.
No, you're from Chile. You'll survive.
I will.
It's from South America. It's from a mosquito. You're fine. You're immune. It was a stomach virus. No, I don't have it. I'm fine.
Oh.
But
yeah. I could use a stomach virus. I wouldn't mind one.
Me too.
Right?
It was a nice
What do you want a stomach virus for?
So I can lose a quick five. I don't know. Why
really?
Not? Yeah, girls are like, yes.
Did
I'm
you
not
ever,
mad for
a good did you ever hear that about models doing that? Where they would apparently leave a shrimp out overnight and then eat it?
Stop!
Yeah,
no,
it's
no,
true.
People eat tapeworms.
Yeah, they would eat it to lose a little weight.
Where can I get a tapeworm?
And then you shit it out.
I'll get you a tapeworm.
You can get it online.
Wait a minute. Stop for a second. What are you... Are you saying they would leave a shrimp out overnight?
Let it go bad.
So it go bad. And then they'd eat a bad shrimp.
To get food poisoning. Because they knew every time you lose 10 pounds, guaranteed.
You just shit and puke.
Shit and puke, yeah.
Why have I never thought of that?
That is a fucking genius idea.
It's pretty good.
It is.
I'm going to do it.
I'm going to do it. Let's do it together. We'll periscope our
food. You should do a video and you'd have a fucking hit viral video.
Yeah. We'll just be in our underwear.
Two girls, two shrimp.
Holding each other's hair.
You guys just shitting in each other's assholes. Eating shrimp. Jesus
I'll
Christ.
Do it. I don't give
I'll
a
do
shit.
It. I don't care.
All right, fucking, first of all, both of you guys, I'll do it. Yeah, no, you won't, first of all. Okay, stop with your tough girl shit talk.
Listen,
okay?
I'm an independent woman. I might.
Not with her in the room. You would do it. You do it by yourself in your little queen's apartment, but she's not doing it.
I live in Hell's Kitchen.
You live in Hell's Kitchen? Where do you live in Hell's Kitchen, bub?
46th and
9th. I used to live on 47th and 9th.
Wow.
See, meant to be. We might have crossed paths.
I know. I fucking.
Now we'll never know.
I hope not. Something I'm not remembering.
It's okay. I got my AIDS test today. I'm good.
Did you get AIDS?
Yeah. Today? No, I didn't get AIDS.
I mean, did you get your AIDS? Sorry. That came out wrong.
No, I did. I forgot to pull my band.
Why
off.
Did you have to get it? Why are you worried about AIDS in 2016? Who are you fucking? What are you fucking guys in the corner?
No, not yet. No, because...
Did you fucking bang Patrick Milligan?
No. Did he tell
Does
you
he
that?
Have AIDS?
No. No. It was my annual checkup, so I was like...
Who gets an
Your
AIDS
annual
test?
AIDS test?
No, why not? Just to know. Although I will say...
AIDS is curable.
It's fucking scary. Like, they were just like, do you want an AIDS test? And I was like, yeah, sure. And then I was like, oh, my God, I can't host the 10 o'clock show tonight. I might have AIDS. What if I have AIDS? What if they tell me right now?
Can I say something to you? Honestly, sweetie, listen. Yeah. In 2016, you have to do some really raw fucking with some really raw people to get some AIDS.
You don't know
it's
where
very
I've
hard.
Been. You don't know where
Are I've you been. Doing that type of fucking?
No, I wish. I really wish.
Oh, my
I'm
God.
I'm doing the opposite of that.
I remember.
Oh like zero.
Oh, boy.
Right now.
Oh.
It's a dry spell. This show just took a turn.
We have dildos.
Rotten shrimp. That's why I said, can I have one?
And Deepu's single, right?
Yes, I will fuck Luciana, I guess.
Luciana,
no
I. Can you at least pronounce my name correctly?
God.
Luciana?
The fuck's your deal, dude?
Luciana.
Yes.
Say my name. Pronounce my name.
Deep.
Oh, I didn't.
She doesn't need to, Deeps.
Oh.
Why? Are you guys fucking on each other? Listen, you got enough. Every guy in here wants you. Every fucking girl wants you, too.
We're going to get our period at the same time after this. We're all...
It's always crazy with the women with dry spell. You could have sex immediately. Within an hour. With someone, good, too. Like a nice person.
Really? Where? I don't really know any
anywhere.
Nice people
downstairs.
Right now.
I mean, go to the olive tree. Be like, boy, am I single or whatever.
Yeah.
Go to Mamoon's. Go to a fucking shawarma plate and just go, oh, my pussy could use some shawarma.
Are you on the Bumble and the Tinder and all that?
Yeah, I am.
Oh,
you're on Bumble.
I'm too picky. I'm too picky.
See, that's not a bad story.
But it is. I used to not be. I don't know. I'm trying to, not be, but it's just
How can you be picky if you're on
somebody that I'm not attracted to?
How can you be picky if you're on Tinder? Wouldn't that being picky just not go on it and wait?
I guess.
No, you're picking. You can be picky on Tinder.
I think you're the
well, that's like going to a buffet and being picky. You know you're not going to eat anything off the fucking buffet.
I go to a buffet and I'm picky, but when I find the thing I like, I
you're
get a
not,
ton of it.
Joe,
she hasn't found
not,
the thing she likes.
Yeah, exactly.
You're not picky.
With food, I am.
You're not picky.
What are you talking about?
You're not.
I'm very
you
picky.
You eat everything.
What are you, crazy? I'm legendary for picky. That's my thing. They call me kids menu. I eat pizza, grilled cheese, and, you know, my sister's ass. I put that in for a laugh. I've heard my sister's
thank
ass.
God.
I'm very picky, but you find the thing you I'm with. You can be picky in Tinder.
Yeah. Well, I'm not on Tinder. I'm on Bumble. And
what's Bumble?
And
what Bumble.
Hinge, which are both the worst.
Bumble is how I describe you walking.
Bumble. Bumble is where the
stretch.
Girl, like, it's like the feminist Tinder where, like, the girl makes the first move. And, like,
you mean
it's stupid. Yeah. The girl has to send the first message within 24 hours or the match disappears.
I like that.
I don't like it at all. I just copy and paste the same message to every dude.
What's the message? You want to host a show? I was like, dude, I got to go film. You want to take over for the month? I'd rather have a chubby Ryan Reynolds sitting over here than fucking me.
It's just like, I try to be witty one time. I don't know what guys want. Usually I'll just be like, hi, how are you?
Ed. Swallow.
Yeah, but first he has to message me back. So yeah, one time I try to be witty. I match with this doctor and I go, hey, what kind of doctor are you? I don't have health insurance. Yeah. And he like didn't write me back for like 3 days. I'm like, I thought that was funny.
But
and then he wrote back and he's like, isn't it illegal to not have health insurance?
Ew.
I was like, you know what?
Off.
Maybe you didn't see my profession listed. It said stand-up comedian. Go fuck yourself. Eat a bag of dicks. Doctor.
Does it say that?
On the thing, yeah, on
it
my...
It says, go fuck yourself, stand up comedian, go fuck yourself, eat a bag of dicks. I wouldn't fucking respond to you either. Fucking diva, twat.
But it's possible...
Lighten up on the profile.
It's possible it might not just might have not have read funny. It might have been like, I don't have insurance. What kind, he might have taken it serious.
Yeah, there's no tone like, in that.
Joke.
We know it's a joke. But
yeah, but he sees you, he might be like, oh, this chick's trying to get free shit out of
me. I mean, I was. He wasn't that cute, but...
Some balding doctor with a fucking Adam's apple.
No, he was kind of cute.
Do you like what kind of dude do you like? You like chubby dudes? Stavros is chubby.
I have pretty low standards for somebody so picky. I'm not gonna lie.
Stavros is a cutie, but I think Stavros.
He just went yes.
She said low standards, yeah. Not the lowest.
But so you're picky and have low standards.
Yeah,
that's interesting.
It's like yeah, it's weird. It's just like when I'm attracted to somebody for whatever reason, they don't have to be the hottest, but like something about them just.
You like a guy with a hairy bum and a yellow anus?
Is that you?
No, that's him.
Yellow anus.
I don't know. That's what I just imagine your anus would be yellow.
I've dated some hairy guys.
He's not Asian.
Like, I'm not, like I said, I don't really, I'm not like one of those people, like, I'm not like, oh, that's a deal breaker.
This is the weird, I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing, but I was talking to this with Jim Serbico. I missed out on the whole, I'm a tech guy. I love fucking Facebook. I was message boards, guest books. I've been into this social fucking tech shit since it started, and I missed the fuck out on Tinder.
I feel the
and
same
I
way.
You're lucky.
You're lucky. Good. Don't
yeah,
lucky.
No, you look at
no.
This is coming from two women.
No.
I'm not lucky because I would have loved to been on the road single. Meeting chicks on
it's
fucking
different for
Tinder
guys than it is.
And just banging.
I feel the same way.
But you don't need to because you're a guy on stage. It's so different for a guy to like a guy on stage gets off stage and all the girls. I mean, I've seen it. It's like ridiculous.
What?
A girl gets off stage and no guy guys are like.
Are you fucking? Are you only
like,
going to Colin Kane shows?
what are you
opening for Dane Cook?
No, it's
no.
True.
But listen
it's
to
true.
Me.
That's
you know what I get
crazy.
After my show?
It's true.
You were so funny. This is my husband.
Yes.
Gary, he turned me on to you.
That's not true. First, you've never banged a girl
I
that
saw
you
at Dan Cook's show. You were funnier than him.
First of all, most audiences are couples, so there's not a lot of single
yeah.
girls. And if they're
true.
Single girls, if they're in a big bachelor
there's
party and they have huge dicks in their head and they've been heckling the whole
girls,
night.
There are a lot
I'll tell
more
you right
single
now,
girls.
Hot chicks at my shows hate me. I guarantee if there's hot chicks at my show, around 20 minutes in, they'll be on their fucking phone because they can't. They need bells and fucking whistles. They need some type of sex. They have to have some type of sexy guy who leans on his ass cheek when he fucking hits a punchline.
That's not true.
Points out to the crowd, then takes a sip and goes, wow, and then goes back into his another joke. I'm telling you.
That's not true. If Bubba, you can make a girl
I'm not
laugh,
asking you. I'm fucking
you're married.
20 fucking years in the business, sweetie pie. I'm fucking telling you. I am not fucking. This isn't a fucking question. This is a fact I'm telling you from doing shows for fucking 20 years, looking out at these fucking women, and they fucking shut down. The only ones that fucking listen are the fans, true fans of mine, who are not all of them. I have some hot chicks, but if there's hot chicks
I'm
at a club that
hot
don't...
chicks. I'm just saying chicks. So the fans, you could probably have banged a couple of them if you didn't.
But who, I don't want to bang a non-hot chick. I don't want to bang
hey,
a chick
listen,
with a fucking a panda tattoo on her fucking
you
ankle.
You can't have it all. Pick your battles.
I don't want a chick with ankles my size.
No, but that's not the point. The point is you could still, like, I'm not saying guys get off stage and bang the hottest girls, but they can bang girls. I get off stage and guys run. They're like,
there's no way guys run from you. I would fucking.
You'd be surprised.
Oh my God. You're crazy. What do they run? You whip your dick out and run after them? Why do they run from you? You're gorgeous.
No, it's different. It's just different. Like, guys are intimidated by a girl talking about.
But I want a girl I'm intimidated by.
A microphone across her face like it's a dick.
I want a girl to squirt in my eyes and kick me and tie me up and call me a whore and bitch.
Well,
I love it. I'd love to fight. I don't mind that type of girl. I love that type of girl. I don't think guys are really guys intimidated by.
Yeah,
guys hide behind
a lot of
social
the time.
Media
I had
now.
A guy. Yeah, I have to
Michael,
hide
what do you
posts
think?
From
Brendan.
Guys.
Brendan, what do you think?
I think it's Craig.
Craig, listen.
I hear. Listen, Philip. I hear that from women comedians. All they're so intimidated by me, and it's like, all right, you're not a fucking brain surgeon. You know what I mean? We're not afraid of stand up.
I would have said Lady Gaga.
You're not because you do it,
because
but
I
guys
do it.
Are because they're like, oh, this girl. Like I literally, there's a guy that like I had asked me out. And we're friends on Facebook, which is like, I never accept anyone on Facebook right away. But he'll like send me screenshots of like posts. They're just funny posts. But he like takes everything seriously and has been like, oh, he'll like bring up stuff about my stand up. And I'm like, no, like it's like too much for them. And it's like, no, they're jokes.
I literally didn't hear a word you just said. I just want to make out with you. No, I'm kidding.
The struggle is real.
I think for me to have Tinder right now, which I'll never have.
Because you're married.
All right. Fucking party pooper, relax. I'm just bummed out. I mean, to be able to go on, like I know guys comics, I watch them and they're on Tinder and they have apps that just check everybody. So they just get them all.
Right.
And then wait for responses and then meet these girls. Like, hey, I'm going to meet this girl. Would you?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It's fucking nuts.
Norman has fucked like 300 girls in the last 6 months. You hear all about it on
Twitter. He should get an AIDS test, not you.
Here's the problem with it. Because I'm recently back in the game. I'm back in the.
Happened?
I was in a relationship for a couple years.
How many years?
I was
slow down.
Almost 2 years.
This is a 2-hour show. Let's slow down. So let's not. Okay, let's slow down.
Tell us all your problems.
Brendan Fraser.
Yeah, Brendan Fraser.
Listen to me.
Almost 2 years. I'm in a relationship. I was on Tinder before that.
Where did you meet her?
In the city. Just met her.
So you met her in New York when you came here from Cleveland.
Life. Yeah.
And you guys were in love?
We were in love.
Did you live together?
We lived together. Yeah.
Wow.
Great girl.
Shared a dresser?
She had a dresser. We had a shared dresser. Yeah. We shared dresser. I got a lot more room in the dresser now.
But what happened?
It just didn't work out. She's in LA now. It was kind of a long distance thing.
Was she in the same business?
She's in the same business.
Well, you never listen, man. You can't.
I'm right here.
It's hot. I'm telling you, dude, guys, it's very rare that you meet somebody with a fucking headshot and it works out.
Yeah.
It's very rare.
Yeah.
It's very not that look at Rich and Bonnie have done it. Joe is doing it.
Al Ducharme and.
But I'm telling you, it's someone is always going to be above the other person, and that will fuck the other person up.
Absolutely,
and that the person that's doing well will have to fucking deal with that. And it's hard to deal with. Is she doing better than you right now?
Oh yeah, just far better than.
Well, let's see what happens when this comes out.
let's see if this makes some waves.
Did that bother you?
Not really. Like I was okay.
Not really.
No, I mean, it's like, I would always say, like, listen, just as long as you know in your heart that I'm funnier than you.
As long as we both know that, it's right. Fine. No, she was cool about it, and
who broke up with who?
It was
same mutual. I'm throwing this mic.
It was pretty much her. It was pretty much her. It was a thing of like, yeah. I mean, it was. I've been telling people it's mutual. You know what
it's,
I mean?
It's
that,
her.
That's nicer.
What'd she
for
say?
Me. She's gone. You know, she's in
Jesus
L.A.
Jesus Christ! You just made me cry.
Yeah,
she's gone.
She's gone.
You fucking benefuck.
Yeah, she's. You know, it's just long distance thing wasn't really. Working.
Have you met Luchana?
I did. We just met.
Hi. Oh my God!
That's an attractive man.
It's an attractive man.
Good jokes.
I think
he's used to women being stronger than him and better than him and moving on away from him. He's already been through it. So he knows how to deal with it.
All right. We'll
what do you
what
think?
Happens. We'll see. Don't put me on the spot. We'll see.
Well, that doesn't sound promising.
Well, that sounds promising.
Yeah, I don't
it does
know.
Not.
Don't put me on the spot. Here's here's the problem with Tinder, and it's great. It's great, man. I've had great luck with it, and it's good. The problem is, it's a very accurate reflection of your fucking level. You know what I mean? Your matches, however ugly your matches are, that's you. You know what I mean? Because they're like, so you can't lie to yourself, like looking in a mirror. If like 3 years ago, before I was in a relationship, I was matching with a lot hotter girls.
Yeah.
Now I'm getting these matches. I'm like, oh, she's not that hot. And then I realize, like, oh, that's how hot
that's
I
how
am.
That's how it matches you?
What?
By the way you look?
No,
because
no,
you have to, I just pick
you have
everyone.
To both agree.
Because I want to see who matches me. So I just match everyone. Because I want to know who's clicking yes on me.
You want
to
know what love is.
That's so funny. Exactly.
Wow. What love
pretty much every guy
watch
just clicks yes
show
on everyone.
I know. But thanks for making me feel better. So, yeah.
Okay. No.
About
with
the
you.
Guys. He's like,
no,
oh,
with
just
you,
so you know,
but with you. No, with you, it's going to be like you'd be a jackpot. Like, oh, fuck, nice. Also, don't worry about what you write. I've never, on Bumble, a woman could write whatever they wanted, and I would respond if they were hot.
By the way, if you guys got
so
married.
So you're also saying I'm not hot because
I'm
all
saying,
these guys
not only
are not. Just, shh, can we move on?
If you guys got married, your name would sound like an airline. Luchana Eyre. That's pretty good.
That is pretty good. I would hyphenate it, though, because my last name's cooler. No
what's
offense.
Your last name?
Gatica
Eyre.
Ooh. Oh, that's cool. That's pretty
Luchana,
cool.
Luchana Chica.
If
I can't say your name.
If I ever married a girl Gatica that Eyre. Fucking that didn't want my last name, I would not marry her.
Well,
that would be
have
a deal breaker.
My girlfriend has a headshot and doesn't want
unless
my last name.
Dude, listen. I would dump. No, I'm joking.
Unless I marry somebody who's Italian or Spanish. I can't be Luchana Smith or like
what
Luchana.
About, yeah.
You know
Luchana
what I mean?
Luchana Eyre. That's beautiful. First class tickets.
It's kind of cool. It's kind of cool.
Why Luchana is everyone McFadden. Thinking I'm going to be into this?
I got to assume.
You're
I mean.
Just saying this.
What are you, fucking dumb?
No, I mean, of course I'm into it. I'm just saying. That's a.
You're into it.
But I feel the same way with Tinder because I have very insecure, low self-esteem. I never knew how to talk to a girl or meet a girl, and that's why I had to marry a comedian. I just had to, we had met.
You didn't have to.
No, I did. I mean, I quit drinking. What am I going to do? Fucking.
I mean, also,
you don't drink
not,
either. That's another thing.
No, I don't drink anymore.
How, I don't know breaker. How the fuck you get laid not drink. That's bananas to me.
I want to see if my wife, just for an experiment, would let me go on Tinder.
Probably not, but keep going.
Just, I mean.
That's cute.
Just to let me go on Tinder, just to see what it would be like. I'm not going to meet anybody or bang anybody, but I would like to just see what that experience is and how, you know, it might just be fucking shit for me. It might be garbage. It might be, oh my God, all these chicks want to fucking meet up with me. I have no idea. And I'll never, ever, ever, ever get to experience that type of, you know, because, I used to have to go. When remember IM, remember Instant Messenger,
ooh,
AIM.
Yeah,
I used to go on AIM, and you'd try to find a chat room, and then you'd see a girl. Like you'd say, you'd look for like Lexa77, and you go like you'd private DM her, hey, and she'd be like, hi, and it was this slow, methodical, fucking, where are you from, Amma? And it would take months. And then hopefully you'd be in a parking lot of a Denny's getting your you know dick sucked by Lexus 667 or whatever it was like
this
7 months later. I mean it took now it's just fucking app on fucking you blah 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 meet down the street. It's fucking crazy.
That's your third parking lot sex reference of the half hour.
I love fucking in parking lots.
But that's what's amazing to me as someone who's very insecure and self-conscious about my looks and teeth and
we are
dick and forehead.
Yes, and lips, mouth.
I'm happy with my mouth.
Chin? Okay. Did you think about your chin?
Think about my Adam's apple followed by my lips, yeah. That area. But like the Tinder or the whatever you call it, Bumble, Smumble, I've already looked at your face and been like, I could fuck a person with that face. That's an amazing tool to have. A woman that's already approved of your face. That would be like, okay.
Okay, but you still have to fucking, you know, show up and get naked at some point.
I look great naked. I'm good all the way but face. The face is a problem.
So what if they had body Tinder? You just put your body, you'd be fine.
It's called Grindr for gay men.
Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Doesn't that do by radius, though?
Yeah.
That's
like there's a guy sitting next to you. And yeah, I have gay friends. One of them the other day was like, I was like, oh, where'd the other one go? And he's like, oh, he went to go fuck this guy. He'll be right back.
Yeah.
And that's how it happened.
Wow.
They also have, I got on Thrinder.
What's Thrinder?
Thrinder's Tinder for threesomes. Right?
Ooh. Really?
I tell my friend this. He goes, you honestly think you're going to go on an app and two chicks are going to select you as the dude to have a threesome with? But it's like, I'm going to sign up
anything?
For the app. Yeah, I mean, no matches. Zero
Nothing.
Matches. Yeah.
Can you turn it on right now and see if you get a match?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I might be having a threesome next week.
All right. Well,
Wait a minute. Stop.
Turn down all the mics.
I love how she went from dry vagina to fucking, that's not a dry spell.
Keeping me in
the
dust.
No, I don't know. I haven't decided yet.
With who?
This guy that I like went on some dates with like years ago and his new girlfriend that I don't know.
So you have to meet the girl?
I guess, yeah.
Does it matter what she looks like?
Oh, yeah.
So are you more into have you been with women?
A little bit.
What's a little bit?
Women have been with me.
I don't know what that means.
That sounds like a rape situation.
Yeah. Are they in a basement patting their dog?
I've been with women above the waist. Uh-huh. Women have been with me everywhere.
Oh. Okay, so you've made out with girls and sucked on a couple of boobies.
Yeah.
And they've went down on you.
Yes.
And you've never went down on a woman.
No, I don't know if I'm into that, but YOLO, you know what I mean?
Why aren't you into, I don't know what YOLO means, but.
You only live once.
Oh, I don't, okay. I'm fine. Well, apparently I've already lived my time. So I don't know what fucking YOLO means.
I thought it was a dessert.
Jesus Christ, what is this?
Yeah, it's YOFRO.
I feel like I'm.
That's the black YOLO.
I literally want to fucking throw a shovel at my fucking own head right now. So you don't know if you want to go down on a woman?
No.
Why?
I feel
you. Is it gross?
One vagina is enough. They're very high maintenance. Like I have to.
They smell off.
Feed them.
Often.
Yeah, they're an open wound. You know what I mean? Mine's beautiful and delicious and amazing, but.
What do you mean
it's
delicious?
Got its moments.
You don't know if it's delicious.
You might have made out after she went down.
Yeah,
you ever put a finger in your vagina like a cake and then licked it? You know, it's done. How do you know your vagina is delicious?
I know. Trust me.
Really? No, I want. How do you know?
I mean,
like my balls are not delicious. I would have to go to a mobile.
See, my balls are bananas. Can I just have a sidebar here?
Your balls are
awesome.
They
smell wacky. They're bright red. They're 7 feet long. It's a wild scene. It's wacky. They're chafed. They're red. It's like a brown stripe down the middle. One is 6 inches lower than the other. It's fucking crazy. It looks like a loose tent with no poles. It's just bananas. My sack, I feel horrible. I've had surgery.
I think
it's crazy. I feel horrible for my girlfriend.
Oh my God.
And she has to look at it. She's adorable. She's like, they're cute. They're great. I love them. Don't change a thing. And I'm like, just please stop patronizing me.
I actually like my balls. Great balls.
My balls are so long
and
crazy.
What kind of balls
do
you
have? If I lay down, they spread from one leg to the other. One on my left leg, one to the right
leg.
They're
like the droopy ones.
They're crazy. Here's why. Because I just switched to boxer briefs. I wore boxers or no underwear for 11 years.
That's why
they just
hanging.
Kept hitting themselves.
Yeah.
So now I got them duct taped to my stomach.
I got my balls can be nice and tight, but then they get nice and like bubblegummy. You know what I mean? But I like when my balls are nice and hanging and you're getting a blowjob and a girl's, you know, your nuts are hanging or when you're banging too.
And they slap
and
you.
I like that. I mean,
I think
girls
like
that, right?
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah. I don't mind that at all, but my balls aren't that.
But some are like fucking cannonball, like just like, I mean, not cannonball, like a wrecking ball. It's just like.
Oh, yeah, like those things you put on the desk in your office that fucking go.
Yeah, yeah.
Just wrap
much.
Around and hit the
That's
girls
a bit
in the
much.
Face.
They're crazy. Yeah, yeah.
Fucking from behind.
No, my balls have hit nipples before in a doggy style situation.
Oh, boy.
But
I sat, actually, my balls were so hot last week when I went to go to the bathroom.
Temperature hot?
I sat on them. Have you ever pissed on your own balls?
Dude, that's a depressing thing. When it's too cold, your dick shrunk up, and your balls are hanging for some reason, and you piss on your own balls, and you're just like,
I pissed on.
On
my balls, for the first time this year, because you sit down in the morning, and my dick was like so... small, it was the morning, and then my nuts were just hanging, and I just pissed on my sack. Yeah. And I thought it was so fun. I was like, I just pissed him, honey. I just pissed in my own balls. And she was like, what? I'm like, yeah, forget it. You don't get it. You need balls.
Now, I still wake up with an enormous erection every morning.
Really?
Every single morning.
That's because
it's bananas.
That's because, dude, you play with your dick too much. We were writing
that
dick.
That about me?
Because we were fucking writing together on FaceTime, and your dick was out all the time.
That's fun. That's fun.
That's not fun for me.
It's funny.
It's not fun for me.
There's something fun about collaborating with another human being, and every once in a while you stand up to reveal that you have an erection. That's funny. That's comedy to me, and it never will not be comedy to me.
But why will you not have pants on while we're doing that?
Comedy.
Also, how long did that go?
Yeah.
At some point, it's no longer a gag if you're maintaining the boner.
Right.
It's not a bit. You're turned on.
It comes back. It was a sequel.
That's my point, is why are you hard? Like, do you love comedy that much that these jokes are making your dick hard?
Bobby, I don't know why I have to talk about this in every episode. It's your lips, dog. You got sweet, beautiful lips. Look at those lips.
I did win.
You're in the shadow right now.
Hey, you got
some
third.
Light on him.
Aww. I did win the lips. Lip off.
I don't like the lighting because your nose is casting a shadow over your sexy lips.
What is this lip off?
Yes, please.
Worry, you would win if you were in Sweden.
You would have won.
Yeah, you would have won. Both on both lips. your delicious quote unquote lips. if you had a fucking a shrimp that's been out a week and a half, maybe. So anyways, all right, let's move on from all this. Did you guys see the Oscars? Who saw the Oscars?
Yes. Great segue.
It is a great segue. Who saw the Oscars? Anybody?
I watched most of the Oscars.
I watched Rock, and I watched a few of the bits, and I can't watch the actors, dude. I can't. They take it so seriously.
Well, they take it serious. This is the one thing.
What do you mean?
I was sad that they actually are making such a mockery of themselves now, and they're fucking, it's like... Every award show is what fucking shitheads they are for accepting these awards. And it's like, I'm kind of fucking bummed out with it. It's like, enough.
Well, I don't know.
Either have the show or don't, but if you have it, embrace it. Right. Be fucking actors. Love it. Don't stop telling us how stupid it is and then taking it and giving us a fucking 10-minute speech. Right. I think the Oscars, myself, I think it's the Emmys, the Oscars, all those awards are fucking great. Because... you're actually, acknowledging great performances and things that have affected me watching and been like, wow, that was awesome. Leaving a movie, I'm a big movie guy. I love movies from fucking from Deadpool to The Godfather, everything in between. I love independent films. I love documentaries. I love it all. I don't understand why they make fun of themselves.
Yeah.
Well, it's like, enough. And then the whole Chris Rock, I thought he was hilarious at first, but then it's like, dude, we get it. Is every joke about, make fun of somebody else or something else. Every joke was fucking about black this, black that.
I agree. I thought it was a bit heavy-handed, and it just went on and on. It was like, give five jokes like that.
Well, it's like, I know what he had to do as a comedian. He had to go, fuck you, I'm never doing this again anyways.
Yeah.
I need to go for funny.
Right.
And I need to go to funny in my funny, which is that.
Right.
But I think you agreed to host, and the hosting job has a responsibility to do it too. But it was like, everybody seems to take these jobs now and go, fuck them. I don't give a fuck about them anyways. And it's like, why would you take it?
Right, that started with, I guess, Ricky Gervais a little bit, maybe even before that, but he kind of shits all over the...
I get it, but he shits all over the thing, but he also makes fun of people,
right.
But he does it up front, and, it was like, fuck.
It's entertaining.
That's why I said, I think I'm, we were Ricky. Talking before, I think I'm racist.
Yeah.
Is because it's the first time I've ever shut the Oscars off. I was like, all right, I'm out. I'm done. I get it.
Yeah.
I'm done.
Well, I mean, the whole thing to me, like, the whole Oscar so white thing. Like, is that just towards black people? I don't actually know. But like Alejandro
right, exactly.
Iñárritu won.
First director to win best director.
Stop. One second. Sorry. Who? Just one more time. I'll be done in 3 seconds. People, get me a towel. I'm going to jerk off in the bomb bandana. Oh, my God. Who was that? Bob? Fuck, I love you. Listen, sweetie.
And now I'm blushing.
Don't blush. God. How can you tell with that tan fucking butterscotch skin?
I told you my vagina was delicious.
I know it is now. I don't care if it tastes like fucking rice and beans. Listen, what is his name again?
Alejandro González Iñárritu.
Oh, wow.
Oh, God. Back up, Lauren. Every fucking week you get everybody. You get everybody. Back up. This one's mine.
That's my people.
We were just fucking vampires. You're right. Well, didn't somebody say that in the Oscars?
Yeah,
somebody finally acknowledged
that. What do you, like, just, you know, black people are like, they're, no offense, black people, but they're like, they're killing us and they're not giving us Oscars. It's like, relax. Other people are getting Oscars. Like, my people are getting, like, people are getting, you know, I'm sorry that the best actor and fucking, I'm sorry that your hip hop movie got snubbed.
Didn't deserve a fucking Oscar. No one in that movie. I love the movie. Entertainment value, amazing. Story, awesome. Did not fucking. No one deserved a fucking Oscar in that movie.
Straight Outta Compton.
Nobody.
Yeah. I hear it's great. If anything, maybe yes.
It was a great movie.
But I don't believe any. I haven't seen it. I don't believe any of those actors. Probably they're all like new.
It doesn't even matter. It's like, look. Nobody deserved the. That didn't deserve an Oscar. What's his name?
Idris Elba.
Thank you. What's his name again?
Idris Elba.
Idris. He deserved a fucking Oscar.
Well, here's what I heard about that.
He deserved a nomination.
Yeah. He deserved the nomination.
But here's what I heard about that movie is that they, Beast of No Nation, they released it on Netflix and in the theater at the same time to be new and whatever. And the Academy doesn't like that because you're fucking over ticket sales.
You're fucking over
ticket
sales.
So the Academy was like, fuck you.
But here's another thing. A lot of people didn't see it because it was hurting children.
Right.
It was fucked up. I didn't want to watch it because it was. I don't like anything that hurts kids. I just have a hard time watching it because of my own childhood or whatever my issues are. When a kid gets hurt, it's very hard to get through. That's why when I watched
Spotlight.
No, I didn't watch Spotlight.
Oh,
not I'm not talking about Spotlight. The Room? Barry Crimmins movie.
Oh. Lucky, you so lucky, me so horny.
Bring that up.
Call Me Lucky.
Call Me Lucky, which was, if you haven't seen that movie, it's a documentary done by Bobcat Goldthwait. Fucking just amazing movie about a comedian. An amazing comedian, by the way. But yeah, it was one of the hardest movies I've ever had to watch in my life. But that's why a lot of people didn't watch that movie with Idris
Elba.
Could he fucking? You know, he used to be a door guy at the Carolines, right?
Really?
He did.
He was a door guy at Carolines.
Really?
Yeah, he was fucking worked the door at Carolines.
He's so hot.
That motherfucker.
Wow.
You into black guys?
No, I've never been with a black guy. But he would be. I have a list of black guys I would.
He's on my list
and
too.
He's on my list.
What about white guys? How do you, have you been with white guys?
I'm all white.
You're all white.
I'm just
all
starting
white.
To turn
you're
the
like
corner
the
to, into my own people. My vagina was racist for a long time too, but I'm starting to. You know, branch out.
I think. Did you? I mean, Chris. I think killed it up front. I think he did like jokes that like white people could laugh at, black people could laugh at. Were comics, and then that whole thing with the movie theater when he went to like some crack lady and asked her. I was like, what the fuck? That's like, what is that?
And the Stacey Dash thing was like so.
That was so awkward. Yeah, weird.
It was yeah.
I just felt bad. I don't know.
Explain that so people who are listening, in case they didn't.
I don't even
She's just like, I don't know what is she.
She's a Fox News. Yeah. She says that there should be no Black History Month, and what else? She said something else that's like ignorant. I don't know, but she's like a. She does something on Fox News, and everybody knows her from Clueless and
you know who
Kanye
did
West
you know
video.
Who was really amazing, and I'm not just saying this because I know him, Louis.
Yeah,
CK. He came out, and it's like there's a certain way you can trash things or trash people or make fun of things, and I just think he's just knows how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Where you're faced with your own fucking reality, where you you know it's like oh my God that's so true. When he came out and said this. Oscar really matters because it's short documentary I mean, this is like, you guys all get Oscars, but you go home fucking millionaires.
Right.
These guys, the guy who wins this one goes home in a Honda Civic. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He has to worry about keeping this in the shitty apartment he lives in. Like, that's a, he has that anxiety when he wins this.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I was like, oh, that's so fucking funny. And, you know, I don't know. It seems like the Oscars have just, it's like, you guys are all shitheads for even wanting this. And then you're watching it, and they're saying you guys are all pieces of shit for wanting this, and you guys shouldn't even give a fuck. And then we, they win, and we have to sit there and we'll listen to them tell how meaningful this is,
right,
to them.
Yeah.
And then you're like, how do I fucking, how do I watch this?
Right.
Either, yeah. Yeah, how the fuck do I watch this? Should I not like these fucking, yeah, idiot millionaire fucking divas for winning shit that doesn't matter?
Right.
Or is this something meaningful to you fucking people? I don't know. It's confusing.
I think Leo deserved the big win.
Yeah.
Everybody, I love Leo.
Did you see the movie?
No.
How the fuck do you know?
Because I know, because he's been,
he's
one of my
hot
favorite,
I get
actors.
It.
No, he's been one of my favorite actors for like, for a long,
yeah,
time.
But, for, but that doesn't,
like,
that
he's
doesn't
never done anything shitty. He's
no,
never,
that's fucking so untrue.
He was a lot better in this movie than he's been in any other.
What's a shitty movie that he was in? Or that he did a shitty role?
I didn't think he was that great in Titanic. I think it was all right. I think the movie was great.
Yeah, but that's,
I don't think it was
Titanic.
That good.
It was like the highest...
Give me some movies.
I didn't say he should
Blood
be.
Blood Diamond,
but it was still great.
Wolf of Wall Street.
Blood Diamond,
Marvin's
In and
Room.
Out of the Accent.
Gilbert Grape.
Gilbert Grape.
It was okay.
Boys,
the
did
Departed.
You ever watch like one of his first
Departed
movies?
Departed was all right. Departed, he wasn't that great.
I thought
Departed,
he was great.
He does
Departed.
An awful
this
boy, Boston
did you ever
accent.
See this Departed, boy's life when
yeah,
he was...
It was good in that, but Departed, he wasn't that good. You can't
I
say he was that good.
No, he does a shitty Boston accent.
I thought he was great.
Dude, he was phenomenal in The Revenant, though. I got
I think
I don't think I can watch that. It's too much for me.
Listen,
like,
if you're
I
a
can't.
Fan of his, you should
know,
watch it because
know,
I'll tell you
I
around.
Just can't be like
I agree with you, dude. It's the best.
I can't I
fucking
like
DiCaprio
be
I've ever seen.
Django, he was the best in.
Django.
I thought he was.
I think
amazing.
Django, he was fucking great in.
You know, he was good in Romeo and Juliet when he was young.
Yeah,
he's good. He's definitely
every,
he's
like,
great.
Yeah. He's great. He's a fantastic actor. Like, I think
Great Gatsby.
Should've...
No, it wasn't.
The Aviator.
Oh, yeah, the Great Gatsby's a piece of trash.
Yeah, that was pretty bad.
I think it was terrible in the
yeah,
Great
but
Gatsby.
I thought he was good.
And Great Gatsby?
Yeah,
maybe
I
the
just
movie
think
sucked.
The movie sucked.
The movie
if
sucked.
You can, he's amazing.
But
yeah,
I, it's like,
exactly. Like, I just think
he's tremendous.
Great. Like, if
ooh,
any,
the beach.
Anything that he does. The beach, yeah.
All right, wait a minute. Let's slow down here. I know this is personal, so you really can't have, like, I can't say I fucking won this argument. I don't think Leonardo DiCaprio is one of our great actors right now.
Oh, I think you're crazy.
Is. Yeah, I absolutely
I think he's
think
unbelievable.
He I've thought about
Wade,
for a long time.
What do you think?
I'll tell you, Karen.
Karen!
What do you,
I think he is, man. I think he is, and I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why I think he is. Because when
Tom
I
Tom Hardy or him?
Tom
Hardy
is,
or him?
Hardy is better,
Hardy.
But I mean,
Tom Hardy.
DiCaprio has a lot much longer list of movies.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. I'm talking acting abilities. Tom Hardy or Leonardo?
Leonardo.
Really?
Yeah. I think Tom Hardy is the best.
Tom Hardy
is the best because he is unrecognizable from movie to movie. And
Johnny
Depp. Wide...
Johnny Depp or Leonardo DiCaprio?
Leo.
I think Leo.
What?
Johnny
Depp's done too much garbage.
No. Yeah,
done, and,
he has,
and when Depp's
yeah.
at his best, when yeah. Depp's at his best, I put him up with Leo. Okay, but he's done. You got. He's done more bad stuff.
Donnie Brasco.
Than Leo. Oh, Donnie.
He
has I love
done
Donnie
more
Brasco.
Bad stuff.
That's
Blow.
Movie.
The movie Blow.
I like. Look, I like
Pirates of the Caribbean.
I like Johnny Depp, but go bring up Johnny Depp's thing. He's been in some garbage.
Yeah.
Right. He's
yeah,
been
see,
in. What's that movie where he was jumping off the thing? That's not a great
They're both great, but just the fact that we're having this conversation and there's a debate. I mean, Leo is unquestionably one of the best actors.
Joe, this is America and we can do what we want.
Unquestionably, yeah, we can. But to me, Tom Hardy's number one right now and has been for the last few years. He's unbelievable. He's unrecognizable between Bane and then Locke, which I think is one of his best movies, which is amazing. That
that's
true.
But
saw.
He does the same
the
thing in all
one,
the movies.
Right?
Yeah.
I disagree.
The whole movie.
Is Locke the car thing?
Locke's in the car. Have you
have
seen
you
it?
Have you seen Locke?
It's amazing.
I haven't seen
you
it.
Gotta
it's
see
amazing.
It. No one else could carry it. He's in a car. The whole movie, there's no one else in the movie.
Wow.
It's him
what?
In a car.
Making phone calls, and the movie is tremendous. And then he also did the gang movie this year where he plays two different brothers, which is amazing. He's hilarious in it.
I saw that movie, The Cray Brothers.
Yes.
And it's one. Have you heard about that?
I haven't heard about the movie. I know about those guys.
It's fascinating because the gangsters from London,
right.
East London, and they're twins. And one of the guys is this really great mobster type dude, cool Frank Sinatra type cool motherfucker. And the other brother's he got brain damage because they got into a fight when they were kids. And the cool one hit the other one in the head and gave him brain damage, so he was fucking out of his mind.
And
he's like crazy, and he's bisexual. Right. He's gay.
Needs an AIDS test, if you know what I mean.
He's gay. So, I mean, just, you know, it's so great that this guy will kill you and fuck dudes. I think that's just so fucking unique. But he played both guys.
Oh, I got to say.
And not one second did you not believe that it was two different people. Twins.
He's also great in The Drop, which is not a great movie, but he's amazing in every scene and carries the movie. Great.
Have you seen Bronson?
Yes.
He's
unbelievable.
Do you know the guy, the older guy in prison he meets with the teacup who's kind of gay?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That guy is supposed to be one of the Cray brothers. He's based on one of the... Because Bronson, in real life, met one of the Cray brothers in prison. Huh, so that guy he meets, and then later he goes on to play him.
Oh, right.
It's kind of a worthless story.
He's also incredible in The Revenant. I thought he was better than Leo in The Revenant.
I thought so, too.
Great.
Well, there's also the interesting thing.
So he's so we agree, except for you, Luciano.
Luciana.
After all this?
I'm sorry, baby. I just wanted you to... I got to dominate you a little bit. I'm from Boston. I know you're Spanish, and I let you get me sometimes, but not all the time. I got to... You know what I mean?
I'm from Boston also. You can dominate me. I'll pay you money to do it.
Yeah, but he's from that other part.
I want to be tied up and just smacked around a little bit, you know, spit in my eye.
I don't know. I thought the Oscars were fucking all over the place this year.
Yeah.
It used to be a ceremony... celebrating these famous people that we put there. We put them there by going to their fucking movies and watching their stuff and giving them our money. They're millionaires because of us.
I think it's a little reverse, though. They were fed to us, and then we bought on. Well, the industry chose these people, put them in the stuff, and then we went, okay, that's the
industry,
what we like now.
But the industry chooses what they think we like. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Yes,
so it is
always,
us.
They're not always with that.
They're trying to give us what they think we like. And then we see these, cool. And now we celebrate this fucking thing once a year that was like, oh, I remember like Oscar night. I remember friends of mine, we'd all pick who's going to win. And and now it's like a fucking joke. It's a joke upon it. It just makes fun of itself. Mm-hmm. It's like, who's going to host and trash everybody for being a star?
But that's always what it's been. But I think sometimes you grow up, and then it changes to you. But
I think Billy Crystal. Billy? Oh, yeah, go ahead, sorry.
I mean, it might just be different for you because you've grown up. Now you have a kid, and what, ba-ba-boo, ba-ba-ba-ba. You change, so the thing changes.
Did you just call my kid?
I didn't call him anything. I'm saying boo-ba-boo. I mean, I think
I got a laugh from Deepu, even though he didn't do it in the mic for the first time. Everybody else, he laughs right in the mic. Ha, 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 me. Cocksucker.
Just being polite, Bob.
All right.
We got some chat if you want.
Yeah, I would love some chat. Let's go to the chat. We have a chat room that we do.
And
is that the kind where you meet people in the parking lot again?
Rick Rock 5 says, for Tom Hardy to be a British actor and to pull off an impeccable, dirty Southern accent is fucking crazy.
Okay.
So he's a good actor.
Okay, we have nothing. I mean, we have nothing to say to that.
Yeah.
Good point.
Accent. Yeah. It's like, well
said.
Do all kinds of accents all the time.
Yeah. Go ahead. What else we got?
John Amato says, this lighting is really terrifying. We're trying new lighting in the studio. I guess people don't like it.
What's wrong with the lighting?
They think it's a little dark. It feels like.
It feels dark.
Terrifying.
I can't see anyone's faces.
Yeah, you can. You're looking
shadowy. You're shadowed a little bit.
I can see everybody's face.
I can see everybody's face.
But you're shadowy.
Fuck him about the lighting. Fuck him. What is he, a key grip? Shut the fuck up. Go ahead.
Christ Killer says... sorry.
Christ Killer. Jesus.
Don't kill my Christ.
He says Bobby should be on Thinder.
I like that. That was.
I don't get it. He's not thin.
No, dude.
Wow.
You said I got thin. You actually. Oh,
I said you look good.
Yeah, but now you said I look bad.
I didn't say you look bad.
You said I should not be on Thinder because I'm not thin.
Did you used to be fatter?
Stand by that.
I don't.
First of all, don't use ever the word fatter around me, okay, honey?
Token White Kid says Depp sucks, same character every time.
Wow, really?
That's silly. That doesn't even make sense.
That doesn't make sense. What else you got? Your fucking chat stinks today, buddy. What's going on? What else you got?
Someone says they would gladly eat Luchana's poop.
Poop or puss?
Puss or poop?
Poop.
Is that an autocorrect? Poop is crazy.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Tastes like fucking
rotten
shrimp.
I didn't say my poop was delicious. I just said my vagina was.
So that's
you got anything else? What else you got?
someone chimes in. Joe's sister's ass is one of the few things that would fit into Joe's mouth.
I don't get that, really.
It's a tiny ass, I guess.
No,
I don't know.
It's also terrible, and it's wordy. There's nothing worse than a terrible wordy joke. Yeah. And the it's not terrible because it's wordy. It's just an added fucking shittiness to it.
Thought it was creative. He's calling Joe's sister's ass small because he's white.
Wow, and nothing worse than somebody trying to defend a shitty wordy joke.
Earlier when you said you were going to eat your, you don't eat, you eat.
No, I remember that.
Yeah, but when you're saying eating ass, you mean the whole. He's not eating the whole butt. Like, that's crazy.
You're right. The asshole would not change that much.
It's not too small to fit. It's spooky. I like the effort, though.
I don't like it. I don't care for it, frankly.
What's the matter, Bob? Did you get sad? What's going on here?
No, I didn't get... What's this for?
I just wanted to give it back to you.
Why? Oh, my sister. Shit.
Her ass?
Yeah.
No, I have to read this real quick. Sorry.
All right, read it. I'll take over.
No, my sister needs is dying from kidney disease, Joe. And...
You said that like me, like that was supposed to hurt, like I said something.
there's actually, I'm going to put a link up, but she needs kidney bad. She was in the hospital again the
other
night.
I'll give her a kidney.
What blood type are you?
I don't know.
What blood type is she?
B plus.
Nobody wants my kidneys.
Yeah.
My
blood type is my outlook on life. B negative. Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez, well.
I can put that. I actually like that joke. I was just reading about
it's not my
sister's
joke. It's
sad
old,
text.
It's an old joke. What's happened with her kidney?
She needs it. Well, she has kidney disease.
What?
And around 17 years ago, she had a kidney transplant. Thank God. The next door neighbor, Neil, gave her a kidney. And then I guess kidneys only last for around 16, 17 years.
Really?
And, you know, everybody forgot about that except for her. We were all just like... And then, you know, now obviously I got sick. So when you have bad kidneys, a cold could kill you. Aww. You know, a simple cold. What?
So even with the transplant, that kidney goes bad also?
That kidney doesn't last forever. No, it doesn't. It only lasts for around 16, 17
years. She doesn't have the kidney disease anymore. Just that kidney is now failing because it's been too long? Is that
yeah,
what it
she
is?
Has a kidney. Yeah, well, her other kidney's bad too. You know what I mean? She has a kidney disease. So this kidney, she needs another transplant. Mm-hmm. She needs to be on the list again, and the donor list... At Mass General, it's a living donor website. Living
I have a
donor
lot of
kidney
friends
evaluation
in Massachusetts. So definitely give me that in Boston. Give me that link.
Yeah, I mean it's weird. I mean, if somebody does say, "Look, I can do this," they pay, her insurance pays for everything.
Mm-hmm.
So you just kind of go in, and someone who gives a kidney, their rehab time is way quicker than the operation is. Way better than it was 16 years ago. They just do everything better now. So it's not like you're laid up for a fucking year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, she needs a fucking kidney. And it's sad, you know. I love my sister, you know, I love her. I was going to say to death. Maybe the wrong thing to say. But, you know, it's just, I couldn't imagine, you know, I mean, having a fucking depend on an organ from another human being. I mean, that's a heavy load to. Yeah. To have that when you go to bed at night, you know, or now she's going to have to go.
So if, how long does it, like, what is the time
two
span
days.
That she, wait, what?
No, I'm kidding.
God, my heart is so,
I got to go.
Why I got to leave? You're fucking,
I'm going to cry.
Hold me.
all right.
Hold my
go.
Sister. I don't know. There's no time. What happens is it slowly deteriorates.
Right.
So she gets sick, and then she has to go dialysis, which is dialysis. And I went to dialysis with her. It's fucking mind-boggling.
Yeah.
What's
just
dialysis?
Born.
What's that, like
she's
yoga?
She gets hooked up to a machine.
Yoga.
And they literally take all the blood out of her body.
Ooh.
And put it through a filter and put it back in her body.
Oh,
it's
God.
4 hours. Mm-hmm. And you sit in this fucking chair. And you have to have, you have to have a permanent stent put in your vein. So they can just hook up to it every week.
God.
Well, every day. Sometimes it's 4 to 5 times a week. So every day, or 4 times a week, you have to go to this place, get hooked up to this machine, sit there, and fucking clean your blood for 4 hours.
Because
that's what your kidney does. So it basically does the job of your kidney until she gets a transplant. Yeah, it's a fucking
It's amazing, by the way,
thing.
That they can do that.
So yeah, Joe, it's like yoga.
Yoga's hard. It's fucking hot in there, dude. That's really a stretch.
Do you do hot yoga?
I do, yeah.
Okay.
Let's talk about yoga. Come on. I mean, that's enough with this. That's scary. Do you have kidney problems? Is it hereditary?
No, I don't. I mean, thank God I don't have anything. I have nothing wrong with me, right? I mean, I go to the doctors once a year. I just went in for a checkup. My blood pressure is fucking perfect. I dropped, 20 pounds.
What about cholesterol? Cholesterol's scary.
What's that?
What about cholesterol?
Everything's great. The only thing I was lacking was, do I have an incest?
Did you get an AIDS test?
Oh, I thought you said, did I do incest? I was like, Jesus. My
not with those kidneys.
I'm messing around with a chick with fucked up kidneys. No incest.
I said I was healthy, not an angel.
I got an AIDS test back when AIDS was AIDS, honey. You know what I mean? Not now. Your AIDS. That
AIDS was
with.
Happening.
I was talking about fucking AIDS was fucking AIDS.
Like Philadelphia AIDS?
Yeah, I got, fucking AIDS AIDS. Yeah.
Of all the ways to tell someone, what's what about your generation, AIDS is the funniest.
Yeah. AIDS meant something.
When I was a kid, we watched the Oscars and AIDS fucking killed you, dude. we were riddled with AIDS and fucking Whoopi Goldberg hosted.
Oh my God, did you guys see that? I'm speaking of the Oscars, tweet about
Oprah.
They thought she was Oprah.
Yeah, Whoopi Goldberg. It's like you people are just ruining
what happened?
Everything. Somebody tweeted wow, Oprah looked great in this dress, and it was Whoopi Goldberg. And I'm like, no wonder everyone's saying everyone's racist. You fucking idiots. They're not racist. They're just fucking stupid.
Fuck the race thing. I want to talk about this. That's fine. Race, I get it. Chris Rock, I think, did a great job, but I think he fucking enough. Yeah. You know what I mean? I think the Oscars this year fucking stunk, and I'm done with them, to be honest, until I win one. And then, why are you laughing?
No. Can I be your date?
Encouraging you.
Sex and Drugs and Rock and Roll, that's a TV show. Oscars more deals with
Yeah, but he
movies.
Might. You don't know where he's going to go after that.
I do.
I think you're going
to
win one.
you're fucking absolutely right. I'm pulling in today to the thing. I see Jessica Kirsten. She's walking panicky. And I go, hey, Chris, Jess, and I'm about to ask her, you want to come up and do the podcast? I go, where are you going? She goes, I'm rehearsing right now with Robert De Niro.
Oh, wow.
And I saw them working together downstairs.
And I'm like, what? And I'm like, oh, she's like, what are you doing? I'm going, I'm going to meet Joe List and a couple other comics and do a little podcast. You know those things that nobody does? Nobody has a podcast, right? It's just me.
No, I have a podcast.
I know. It's Murray Mondays with Memories. I was like, fucking A. And I love Jess. It's great for her. But it's like, fucking wow. That's, you never know. I mean, you're sitting here doing spots at the Cellar and doing YouTube videos or Facebook videos. And now she's working with fucking De Niro. So you really never know in this fucking business.
Amy Schumer was nominated for a Golden Globe. And a SAG or just Golden Globe?
I don't really know.
Okay. I saw Jessica having that meeting.
It's the most awkward show I've ever had. It's my fault because I usually have just one new person on, but I had two.
Don't look at me when you say that. You love me.
Great. So it's me. Well, you love me.
Sorry,
so okay.
Dan.
Well, all right. Well,
did she call you Dan?
Yeah. Relax, Lucy.
Brendan.
She called her Lucy. She'd be Desi. Because she's okay.
Yeah, we get it.
Wow. Can I have the bandana, please?
It's a bomb, Dana.
Yeah, can you? Yeah, all right, here you go. You want to wrap this around your head?
I don't know. Nothing. I saw him wiping his mouth.
No, that was a racist.
Was on your balls.
That was a racist Spanish joke.
Touche.
You know, Chileans in their bandanas.
That was the old maid joke I was trying to flip out at you. Anyways, I want to talk about this. The outfits that, Whoopi's outfit, I don't understand it. I don't fucking get fashion whatsoever.
She's nice titty tat.
Well, that's not really fashion.
What is that? What are these fucking dresses that they're wearing with these a fucking 12-foot ribbon on her tits? They look like fucking ugly Christmas gifts. I don't fucking get it. I don't understand it.
I know.
It's fucking, Patricia Arquette. I love her as an actress. She's my favorite movie of all time, True Romance. She's so sexy. And then she walks out, and she looks like just a shitty elf.
I didn't see her.
I don't know what dress it was, and it's ruffles and ribbons and fucking, it looks like just shitty packaging.
I think designers just send them to them for free, and then they just wear whatever they like.
But you can't say, I mean, does anybody in her camp go, nah?
Probably not.
I don't know if Patricia Arquette has a camp.
I know. I don't think she has a camp.
She's not in the camp place anymore.
What about the broad who from Mad Max who won?
Charlize Theron?
No.
Did you see her dress?
No, with that lady. And everyone was saying, I know who you're talking about, the costume lady.
Yes, ma'am.
And everyone, thank you. And everyone is like, oh, she's a hero. She didn't dress up. And it's like, she just wore like a motorcycle jacket. Like, yeah. It's an event. Put on a something.
Yeah.
That's why this fucking whole Oscars, it was like, it was about black issues. It was about the Oscars stink. And then some chick walking down with a fucking Pinky Tuscadero satin jacket. It's like, I was like, where the, what is this? Become like, what is this?
Right.
Like, nobody gives a fuck anymore. Yeah. Like, should I, like, that's, it was fucking weird, man.
Well, it's interesting because I feel like the lead story the next day used to be who won best movie, won best actor, and it's not anymore. Well, now
what is it?
Now the lead story is what joke was most offensive, and who had the craziest speech. That's it. That's if you go on CNN, it was all about that lynching joke. Where it's like, it didn't used to be like that. It used to be, the host was secondary.
But that's not the Oscars. That's our culture. No.
Well, right, but there are, that's reflected in the
what did you think about that joke?
I thought it was a great joke.
Joe?
I was reading it on subtitles. I was at the stand. The joke was, who cares about
best
doctor?
Are you trying to be smarter than everybody else?
No, I was working.
That was a joke.
Oh, okay.
Like, because you're reading instead of...
Oh, I get you.
Nice talking to you. I have the bandana. I'm just going to keep the bandana, and I deserve it.
Yeah, bomb-dana. Bandana kind of lessens it.
Bomb
it makes it seem like, bomb dana. It means you bombed.
Yeah, I'm bombing.
Got it.
We have the name of the show. Bobby Bombs.
Yeah, I didn't mind the joke. It was fine. It's whatever. But first of all, like, I just don't think, like, I think for most of the Oscars, I don't know if there's a lot of lynching going on. I think that was pre-Academy Awards, probably.
Yeah, but, I think so, too. Yeah. When did the Academy Awards?
Definitely not. The Academy Awards started in, like, the 20s.
So we're talking lynching in Connecticut.
Oh, lynching in Connecticut.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. I mean, there was lynching
that
at
went
one
out
point.
In the 80s.
At one point, lynching and the Oscars went on at the same time. But it's fine. I don't know. It was a good joke. I mean, it was crazy. It's primetime ABC. They went for it, obviously.
I thought it was a good joke. What did you think about it?
I don't know what joke we're talking about. I was actually on an airplane during the Oscars, but
I saw
some of the.
He basically said that back in the day, black people didn't worry so much about how many black people were winning Oscars because they had more important issues, like aunt whatever her name.
Like their grandmother swinging
from a tree.
Who said this?
Chris Rock.
Oh. But doesn't that imply that there's no, now this is the biggest problem, because they're still being shot in the streets by police? So it's kind of a weird. But
you can't.
The joke's fine.
It's a fucking joke. The joke is. They had more important shit to worry
about. Let's talk
about it. And they should have more important shit to worry about now than whether you win a fucking Oscar, people being shot and killed.
That's the thing.
You know?
Is like we have a black president. Like, you know, like we're really like sitting there boycotting like this. You know, it's not like, oh, the whole world is racist. A lot of people are. But it's like.
I don't think you just said anything. you're pretty, but not that pretty. I literally was with you, and then I went, she said,
no, I think
like
you're just not
three
paying
times.
Attention.
I mean,
I do say like a lot.
You
I
do.
Won't, I won't lie.
I don't know. I
click like a lot on Facebook.
No, what was racist is that they played Fight the Power when they ended the show.
Did
you
really?
Hear that? Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It's fine. I mean, we're fucked, dude. I mean, it's a wrap.
Yeah.
It's the way we know show business, the way we know entertainment, I think it's just a fucking wrap. You know, we're not going back to the time when Billy Crystal would do a song and dance number and we could just sit there smiling. just a bunch of white people going, yay, elbowing each other.
But it will if five people get black people get nominated next year, they'll just move right on.
I'll call it right now. Do you think a lot of black people next year are gonna be nominated?
Well, that's what's interesting because a few years ago, 10 years ago, whatever, no black people got nominated, and it was a big deal. People talked about it. And the next year, Halle and Denzel won, and then people started to go, clearly it's just a makeup call. And you're like, well, how are we going to be happy?
Yeah, exactly.
So now it's a makeup call.
Exactly.
So what is it? And then I have this problem. I was talking to some black friends about it, and they were like, I was like, well, Halle Berry, were they just not written? Like, yeah, but she got fucked by Billy Bob. That's how you have to win an Oscar as a black person. You're going to get fucked by Billy Bob Thornton. I'm like, well, isn't that racist? Getting fucked by a white guy is so bad. She's great in the movie. And then, like, yeah. You can win it for Precious. She won. And like, yeah, but that's how they portray a black person. AIDS and fat. And I'm like, well, what about Tom Hanks? He won for having AIDS. You know what I mean? Like, it's a great performance.
Right.
So it has to be a very specific performance for a black person to win, for people to be happy. And it can't be next year because they protested too much. It's very confusing and odd. And I feel like there's bigger problems, and a lot of people didn't get nominated that could have been. I thought the kid from Room could have got nominated,
yeah,
but he didn't get nominated.
No.
So, but you know, it's 12 Years a Slave won. Were they just they took a year off from being racist? They just skipped that year.
Right.
They decided not to be racist that year, which it was not the best movie of the year, by the way. But it won.
Yeah.
And so I just don't get it. The argument, this big argument that Hollywood, Hollywood. Is racist? It seems crazy, but I'm also naive and I'm white, so
how
I have to deal with this.
How the fuck is the most liberal fucking place in the world, in the country, Hollywood?
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it's run by fucking the most liberal motherfuckers ever.
But I do think sometimes maybe I'm in a box and I'm naive because I'm just reading, you know, liberal comics feeds and I'm in New York City and I hang out with good people. But then I do go to, like, Pennsylvania and four comics in front of me make, like, actual racist jokes and the crowd's like, yeah! And I watch a Trump rally and they're like, yeah! And I'm like, well, this is horrifying.
No,
so I'm not trying to act like there's not racism. I just think there's
I think
year of 20 people not there are no black people getting nominated for an Oscar is not crazy. And I think
you make a good point, dude. There, because we're in New York and we're in our own bubble, and the comedy community, I think, is really diverse, especially now. There's a lot of women, there's a lot of minorities. And we're kind of, once you're a comic, you're just a comic. You're not black comic. We're just, if you're a good comic, you're a fucking comic. So I think it is weird. But when you do go, like, I've been to cigar places in, like, Pennsylvania. And, you know, it's really a little creepy, the conversations. Like, the conversation gets a little fucking hair. It goes from, you know, how to field dress a deer to, you know, they start using the word they.
Right.
And them, and you're like, ooh.
We're kind of in a bubble here, so you forget.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, yeah, I guess you're right with that.
But well, you also realize when it comes up that quickly with a guy they don't even know, when, like, if I'm on the road and a guy starts telling me sort of racist stuff,
right.
And I'm like, I just met this guy. Could you imagine how he is around his friends?
Right.
You know what I mean? That he's just a stranger. Right. He's just like, how about these guys?
Right.
And you're like, whoa, I don't know you.
Yeah. So all that stuff is significant to me, and obviously the incarceration numbers are fucking wild, the poverty numbers are wild, the police brutality numbers are all crazy.
Okay, but
the Oscars, I can't
see. But you have to do the numbers too of, like, okay, there's way more black people in jail than white people, there's way more white people than black people.
Right.
So,
right.
I mean, you can't do that number without doing that number.
That's what I'm saying. That's problemsome, and we have to figure that out and get to it. That's why it's so, with those numbers being the way they are.
Is that a word?
Problemsome?
I'm dumb. I'm probably the
problematic.
Problematic?
I'm going to say I'm the dumbest guy in the room, but that made my eyebrows go up. I literally
Is that not a word? Problemsome?
No,
problematic?
No, I don't think
it's problematic then.
Problemsome? In the middle of it,
Troublesome's
like a song.
Troublesome is a word.
It literally goes problemsome. Yeah, if you're a Muppet or you're on Sesame Street, problemsome might work.
Pull it up. She's got something there.
If you ever have to stop to say
she's
the rest
Jersey,
of the
I don't
word,
trust her.
It's not a word.
It's not a word.
Dude, in the middle of it, if you have to go problemsome.
Oh, it is. Problem sums.
No, that's math. That's a children's math.
She's from Jersey. I knew she'd go, wait, it is. My father said problem. I was a problem sum.
All right, well, it's problematic, child. You fucking cunts.
Don't
all
get
right?
mad at me. Look, I get fucking yelled at all the time for being dumb. Take a hit.
I took a hit, and then I called you cunts. What are you talking about? I sat here. Y'all had your dumb fun.
I also like realized you said it, and then I looked at Bobby to make sure it was okay for me to interrupt you because I'm new. I was like, and I saw he was kind of looking at you, and I was like, all right, I'm gonna say something.
Only your look to Bobby made him think that it might
be
a problem.
No, he.
I literally went.
Yeah, we.
I went like that.
Other.
We both went. What the fuck,
yeah.
Dude? If we had instant replay.
Yeah, Deepu, bring that up.
Yeah, bring
run
that
it back.
Up.
Well, whatever.
I hate my fucking fat jawbones from eating so much. Just right here looks like it just a fucking hippo.
What?
Sorry, nothing.
No.
I just hate myself. Sorry.
I love you.
Anyways.
Your cheek looks problemsome.
It's...
Oh, fuck.
Yikes.
Hang on. Uno momento. Go ahead.
It's strange to me to have... There's 20... There's fucking... First of all, there's 300,000 performers, a million...
Yeah.
And 20 of them, none of them were black that were nominated. I don't think it's a crazy, huge problem.
I think Ice Cube's kid actually said, I like what he said. He was like, look, it's just go make better. Let's go make more shit and go make better shit. Just go be more. Go be creative. You didn't pick us this year. Well, fuck you. We'll just go make more shit. Let's, as black people in the black community, let's get more directors, more producers, more writers, more stars. Let's go do shit and just keep doing it. And then become undeniable. Become fucking undeniable. I mean, that's what you have to do as a comic. Look, in the comedy community, I'm not comparing the black fucking struggle to comics, you know, comedy struggle, but I mean, there's what the industry likes, and, you know, and then there's funny people, and then there's everybody in the middle. I mean, you sometimes you have to become unfucking deniable, because they're not going to pick you, you know? I'm not fucking young minority. I'm fucking what the industry has grown to hate, a fucking, you know, a white married dude. They don't fucking want me at any fest. They don't want me on any channel, but I have to do what I have to do. I have to become funny. I have to go to clubs and just kill, get my fan base, do my podcast, do whatever the fuck I have to do, go to acting class, become good at everything I could possibly do, because they're not going to give me the opportunity. They're going to give some guy with fucking 10 minutes of mediocre material, but, you know, he looks cool. You know?
Yeah, you don't look cool.
I don't. Of course I don't. I look like Michael Chiklis.
That looks cool. I didn't notice that before.
Oh, this one?
No, the other one. Oh, sorry. Stop trying to show me all your guns.
I know. That's why I did that.
I saw Michael Chiklis go into a hotel in Midtown with four hookers one time.
Dude, he's married with kids.
He wasn't Chiklis.
That might have not have been Chiklis. This was years ago.
Yeah, please don't do that to any man on my show.
I didn't know this
not
was.
Not that his wife was a fan.
I didn't know Michael Chiklis was married.
Every time he comes home, she goes, you know what, dude? Stop fucking doing that.
It might not have been him. I'm really backing this story up a little bit to cover for Chiklis.
Can we edit? Let's just edit that out.
Can we edit that? I've always said I'm not going to go on a podcast and throw Chiklis under the bus.
All right, we'll do
yeah,
that.
Take care of that.
Special order?
Sounds like he was Chick-full. I wasn't sure if you guys heard the first one.
That was a very problemsome comment.
What do you got in the chat, kid?
I don't have a lot queued up. You want to give me a minute? Come back then?
I guess. I don't think you gave me a choice. You asked. Oh, yeah. So, anyways.
Want to take a pee break?
I could pee.
All right, let's take a break.
But I got to hard out in like a half hour.
We're going to do a 10-minute break, and everybody's going to pee. All the women are going to pee. All the men are going to hold it in like men.
I have to pee real bad.
Like I said, all the women are going to pee, and the men are going to
Are you calling me a woman?
Yes, I am. Vag lips.
That's a nice compliment.
Today it is, in this fucking day and age. Back in the day, it'd be a fucking bitch.
Yeah, back in the day when AIDS was tough.
I just shut the podcast off. Oh, hang on. All right.
Did I not get my line in?
Nope, you didn't.
Well, we got it here. So.
Hang on. We got it over there. All right, ready?
I guess we're using this.
No. I don't know. No, hang on one second.
I do. I'll be quick. Okay, yeah, you're all a guy.
Deepu, one second.
Yep.
We're not using that. We're just going back to this, all right? Okay, sorry. I fucked up. I hit the button a little quick. We're going for a break right now. We're going to take a pee. We'll be back in 5 minutes, okay?
You're listening to Robert Kelly's You Know What Dude podcast on Riotcast.com.
Wow, we're back. This show today, first of all, has been different. Look, man, we usually have like fucking 8 people on. It's crazy. I actually enjoyed this episode a lot. It's been, I've been a little out of it myself. So I apologize, but you guys are fucking great. We were talking about the Oscars before we went on piss break, and you know, it's. I wish I had more of a fucking opinion of like a formed opinion about what the fuck happened on it, but you know, I didn't watch the end of it, and I think it's fucking stupid, but it's sad to me what the fuck has happened to these things. Every award show is now just making fun of itself. Like, it's stupid that we're doing this, but we're still doing it. So, mm-hmm. Fucking, what the fuck's going on?
But we do that all the time. That's all we do.
I know, but it's what we do.
Right,
it's not what
exactly.
They do.
Exactly.
Actors had that thing about them, which I kind of like. You know what I mean? I kind of like them being that way. It's almost like, you know, like Deadpool. The movie, you've seen Deadpool?
No.
Have you seen Deadpool?
Yes.
Have you seen Deadpool? Do you want to go see it tonight?
Yeah.
Oh my God. I totally put my dick in popcorn for you. I'm sorry. That's just rude of me to say. I'm sorry, babe.
Yeah, it's harassy and
never,
it's creepy.
It's harassy. And I called her babe when I called. Hey, babe, listen.
It's really problemsome.
And speaking of problemsome, you can get butter and salt in your dick hole. And that causes, that's how you get kidney disease.
That's how you get herpes.
That's how you get AIDS.
No.
That actually cures herpes.
Are you serious?
No. Dude. Not at all. Dude, my herpes dick, dude. Dude, I put my dick in popcorn. It's all gone, fucking kid.
One time.
Dude, salt and fucking butter. Cure herpes, kid.
One time, my buddy, after fucking a very, what do you call it? What's the word?
Promiscuous.
Yeah.
Dude, have you what the
promiscuous?
I only have glasses. People think I'm smart. I have glasses. I didn't go to 1 second of college.
Yeah, but before you said that, you didn't think. What's the word? Yeah. Promiscuous. That didn't sound right.
Close.
Do what I do. Wait for somebody smarter to give you the world.
God damn it! I need to go to a different podcast for that.
Yeah, you do.
So anyway, I thought Brendan was blowing me for a second. Promiscuous. He had sex with a promiscuous girl, and then afterwards I went in the bathroom and I'm like, dude, that girl's fucking crazy. And he was dumping Listerine and hydrogen peroxide on his dick.
Ew.
Thinking that combo.
It was just foaming up like a fucking stroke victim's mouth.
Yes.
Gross.
Whoa.
Can we talk about Leo's mouth? What was he doing?
Talk more about how you hate wordy jokes.
He was dipping. Yeah, he had a lip in the whole time.
He went and gave a speech with fucking dip.
I think it was out for the speech, but he had a lip in the whole time. But are there pictures of it? He definitely.
There's no way he was dipping.
He was dipping.
You don't dip front row at the fucking Oscars in a tux.
If you're Leo,
on your night.
No, you don't.
He was dipping. He looked to me like he was.
I think he had Bell's palsy.
Could be. A lot of times those are interchangeable.
That's my biggest fear, that I'm going to wake up with Bell's palsy one day and still have to do the show.
Bell's palsy.
I don't think he was dipping.
Was Leo chewing tobacco during his Oscar
Can you read
speech?
That in your head and then tell us the information? It's like fucking talking to my agent. He will be there at 2. Pick up at airport. What did you want to do? Airport. Fuck off.
Look at that.
Oh, fuck him. So good looking.
So he's got a dip in.
Even with his
good
dad.
For him.
First of all, can you go to a news site instead of a chat room? They're doing what we did. I don't want to do it twice. I think he was. Me too. Here's a picture of him when he was dipping on the beach.
Go to a legitimate, hard-hitting news source.
Yeah, TMZ.
That's talking about Leo's fucking dip.
Dude, act like they're not. They all fucking
they
do now. There's no hard-hitting news. Name one hard-hitting news source.
My sister's cunt. All right, come on. I'm kidding. I don't know why I said that. That's crazy. She's sweet.
I was trying to veer this in another direction.
What direction? I got a hard out.
He's
forget.
He's got a hard out.
What's your hard out?
I thought he touched his penis. He was touching his phone. 4:50
p.m.
Okay, 4:50. You're fine.
I got 18
I'm wide open.
Why do we have to stop because you leave?
I'm not saying that. You're projecting. I'm just saying I have to leave
Don't
at
tell me what I'm doing, dude.
And you can keep doing whatever nonsense you do when I'm not here. Go ahead.
Are you on your phone, you fucking...
No,
no she's playing with the cord. She's nervous. We're trying to hook her up.
Nervous,
you're harassing her.
I'm not nervous.
You're not
nervous.
I'm not harassing you. Am I harassing you?
No. I've had worse.
Look at me.
That's a hilarious answer. No.
You've had worse?
Yeah.
What is worse?
I go on Gavin McGinnis show all the time.
What's wrong with old boy? I love Matt Gavin. What's wrong with that?
I love him too, but he's... I mean, I don't care.
What does he do to you?
Last time...
Jesus Christ.
The first time he said... That he didn't see my ass until I was leaving. So then that was the first thing he said when I came back. And then he made me like spin around and like, and then I was like, okay, wait, what's happening here? But he likes to talk about what he would do to me.
At the end of it, are you alive?
Oh yeah. He loves me. We're buds.
All right. Well then he's actually, I forget. well, yeah, no, I'm kidding.
And he's married too.
What?
Have you ever been with a married guy? Thank you. That's all I need. That's all. How about we're good?
No, I'm not sure. I think so, but I don't. I think. I was sleeping with this baseball player, but I didn't know he was married.
Whoa. Was he? Was he a baseball player or a dude who played baseball?
No, he was a baseball player.
Legitimate, like on a team,
yes.
Like a team that would be like, wow, like
yes,
like you'd pay to see, not like a fucking the Redbirds or some shit.
No,
oh, he plays on the Mockingbirds.
No,
yeah, the Dirty Devils.
No, it was.
It's an actual team.
Yes,
with a logo. The logo is like legitimate.
I'd be okay.
It's not a fucking train, right? It's not like a choo-choo train logo.
I'd be fine if the rest of the show is just you making up minor league baseball teams.
Yeah. No, he played major league baseball.
Wow.
He's not on the Hives, right? It's just a bumblebee hive.
He plays for the Pittsburgh Porcupines.
The Tennessee Tenders.
Oh, I like that. Alliteration.
I've fucked a couple of D3 college softball players.
Oh, wow.
if anyone wants to, ask me anything. If anyone wants the deets on that.
Have you ever fucked somebody famous?
What about fucking someone that's about to be famous?
No, I've never fucked it. I'm trying to think. No, I mean, I don't know why I was trying to think as if there would be like, oh yeah, the famous person I forgot about fucking. And no, of course I have.
Yeah, that's like an easy answer. Yeah,
I fucked Drew Barrymore when she was on Poltergeist. Whoa. You fucked somebody. So apparently you fucked somebody famous.
I fucked a few famous.
A few?
Whoa.
Wait a minute.
Famous one.
Bill, girl.
Hang on one second. Famous in our business or famous in like... Okay, baseball's one.
Why don't we just name names? What is it? I got a hard out, Bobby. Enough of this playing around. Who's who? Give it to me.
Hey, Joe, I got a hard out.
You got 15 minutes. You're good. Let me fuck
Anthony Hopkins?
No.
You fucked Anthony Hopkins? When did you fuck Anthony Hopkins?
What is happening?
What did you... Have you fucked a famous actor?
Yeah.
Hit us with it. Come on, just hit me
with
it.
No, girl. I'm never going to tell you.
I'm going to tell you. We don't want to know.
I signed an NDA.
Okay. You did?
He played for the NBA?
Wait, he made you?
No, I'm just kidding. I didn't
listen to me.
Anything.
I know. Can I tell you who it is?
Yeah.
His name's Ryan.
No.
Who it is? Because you look down. His name's Ryan.
No.
Ryan Gosling.
What about
no, I yes. wish. I wouldn't fucking be here if I fucked Ryan Gosling.
Yeah, you would. He fucking wouldn't. He'd dump you and you'd still be
here. No, I'd find. I would.
Ryan's fucking taking you with him to Hollywood?
I would spit the cum out of my mouth and inject it into my body.
I'd follow him around.
Hang on, that's scary. What she just said was the scariest thing I've ever.
Scary. It was hot.
I would do that to Mark Wahlberg in a second.
I would do that to many people.
You'd spit the cum into your vagina?
You save the cum in your mouth. You take it with a turkey baster. You just shove it up.
Listen.
Hear that,
both
Brendan?
I want both of you to slowly walk out of the studio and never come back. You understand the options that women have that we don't have? You can stop. Listen to this option you have. You can literally fuck a famous guy,
swallow
his cum, hold it in your mouth, and then jam it into your pussy when he
does
leaves.
Does that work?
Yes, it does work.
No,
yes.
It dies in the air.
No,
I heard.
No,
I read
that
blog.
That's absolutely untrue. Women have fucked. Fucked guys, let them come in the condom, take in the condom, and put it in their pussy, and have
women
gotten
have
pregnant.
That,
I'm into
and
that.
You get a payday.
Yeah.
A candy bar?
No. Well, it depends.
Sounds like a great deal.
If he's fucking on an Italian basketball team, you get a fucking candy bar.
If we guess who it was, would you tell us?
Yeah, you're never going to guess.
Jimmy Stewart.
You fuck Jimmy Stewart too?
Smart Joe, start at the beginning.
What are we talking? Like, is he like an extra?
I want to ask you this question. Has he been in movies that we've seen?
Yes. 100%.
We know he's white.
Okay, so he's famous. Is he A-list, B-list, or C-list?
Steve Buscemi.
I would.
You fuck Steve Buscemi?
I don't know.
Is he an actor and comedian
or just
actor?
Can you let her answer the first question, for God's sakes?
What's the first question?
I'm never going
to
tell
A, or B, or C?
You just told me to hurry it up, and now you tell me to slow down, you fucking promiscuous person.
I'm trying to get an answer out of her.
Well, he's done, like, TV and movies. You would definitely recognize him from both.
You fucked Al Bundy.
Ted Danson.
No.
Is he living?
Yes, I have daddy issues, but geez, guys.
Does
he aim higher?
Does he live in New York?
No.
He lives in L.A.
All right, so he's an L.A. actor. He's white, TV, Corbin Burnson.
He lives, what the fuck are you talking about?
He's not a stand-up comedian, though.
No.
So it's not a, famous comedians, we're not counting, right?
We got it narrowed down. It's not Corbin Burnson.
Good-looking guy?
Very good-looking.
Oh.
Younger or mature?
Vincent D'Onofrio.
He's mature.
Mature.
He's mature?
He's mature.
So 40.
Maturgasm. Thank you. I got 12 minutes to nail this down.
Yeah, we gotta get it before
TV
you leave.
TV and movie.
TV and movie, but mostly TV.
No, TV. I think mostly movies, actually.
Can you mostly give us a movies.
Channel
well,
on
there's
TV?
A couple. I don't know. Whereas there's.
Now, is he a bad boy or a good boy on the movies?
Say bad boy.
That's a good question. Bad boy or good boy?
Good.
He's a good boy.
This is so fun.
Okay, so now, anybody in the chat room, please feel free to yell out names.
Someone says Charlie Sheen. As a
no.
Fuck Charlie Sheen.
No.
Two beans!
I just got my
A's. That's why you got tested.
No, but that was, I'm not going to lie, there was a second where I'm like, oh my God, because I'm from LA. I'm like, for 1 second, I was like, what if I fuck someone who fucked someone who fucked Charlie Sheen? Like, maybe I have AIDS.
Emilio Estevez.
No.
You fucked him. Okay. Bobcat Goldthwait.
Dennis Leary.
No, he's
TV,
married.
Movies.
No, he's married.
All right.
And he, no, lives but, in, he lives in Connecticut.
But he has a... No, I can't.
Oh, it's related to Dennis Leary.
He has a what?
I can't. No, I can't.
It's related to Dennis Leary.
I got
someone
it.
From the same lot.
I got it. I fucking got it.
Who is it?
You fuck Kevin Costner.
No.
Ooh. I think it's someone...
He was sold on
okay,
that
now, so he did more movies than TV, but he's on TV. Now,
is
he on TV now?
He's with Leary.
Is he on TV now?
No.
He's not on TV now.
Actually, yeah, he is.
He has a show on TV? But, like, is it on or is it on reruns?
I can't. I've already...
You can tell me. You can tell if it's on reruns or if it's on. Is it on or is it on reruns? It's on.
Okay. Ooh. So it's a successful
I know it
sitcom.
Is. I know
she
it is.
Dennis Leary.
I got it. You fuck Chris O'Donnell.
No.
Ooh, that's not bad.
That's a good one.
Wait.
I can't. That, I can't say anymore.
The guy from
you don't have to. We're gonna say it. Right. We're gonna solve it. See your eyebrows
so he's
go up.
Sure.
I'm
he's
done.
What?
Done.
Ryan Reynolds. What about Ryan Reynolds?
No,
he lives here.
No,
he lives here. Oh,
okay.
He lives up
I
by
wish.
Me. And besides, I fuck him.
Okay. Yeah. He's mature. He's been on TV
you
and
if
movies.
He fucks Ryan Reynolds.
He has.
What do you mean? You wouldn't fuck me? Although, oh God, she just ruined it. It's all over. I don't want her anymore. That's the way I am. I'm stubborn.
Okay, we can get this.
Right, just
we can
think
do this.
Successful shows on television.
Something with Dennis Leary. He's worked with Dennis Leary. He's been on TV. What else has Leary done besides that bullshit he's doing now?
I know who it is.
Keep saying that. You always get it wrong.
Shut up, you dummy. We got fucking 15 more minutes left
I'm
of
not
the show.
I'm done. I'm not speaking anymore
I know
on
it
the
is.
Subject.
I know it is.
That was the most kid brother comment of all time.
I know
that's
it is.
Role.
And
keep
I'm not
that.
I'm I shut up. I know I keep saying it. I'm trying to fill space, you fucking quad
brother. Oh, William Shatner. TV, movie, good guy, mature.
John Stamos?
I wish. No.
Ooh, Dave Coulier. Cut
no.
it out.
No.
What are you doing, Bob?
I'm done talking. I'm done.
I know it is.
I'm done talking.
Are you showing us or are you texting
I'm
the
gonna
person?
Fucking show. Can you settle? Can I have a fucking second to breathe?
I have a heart out.
John Corbett.
Whoa, that was it.
I got it.
Do not.
I got it.
Let me see.
I got it. I can't tell.
How did you get that?
Because I'm the fucking man. That's how Gary.
That's good.
Gary, I'm the fucking man.
This is disappointing. I have no idea who that is.
Yeah, well, yeah. You don't need to know.
Oh, that's
I
a
know.
Bummer.
All right, we all keep
it. That was crazy.
Yeah, that's
that
crazy.
Was the coolest
thing
I've ever seen.
You don't understand. I should have been a PI.
That's
what I'm going to do. If
awesome.
I don't make, by the time I'm 50, if I don't make it, shut down the comedy, and I'm getting a fucking hut up in Westchester, and I'm solving crimes in Manhattan. That's my thing.
I think you got the wrong letters. You should be an MC.
I can't believe
it. I got it. I knew it. I know what you like. I know what you like, girl.
Who was that
I had to
guy?
Go. I had to go into your. I had to go into your little style, what you kind of like in a dude, and then I figured out. You know, I figured out the. Yeah, I got you. I got you.
I don't
now,
know why everyone
if you,
isn't.
If
impressed.
You want me not to tell people,
that's amazing.
We're gonna have to work something out. Because you know what I mean? I'll do fucking 9 shows about it, and this is my biggest month ever. By the way, what?
Can I ask how you met this guy?
How do you think? Look at her.
I
how do you think she met him?
Chess
she
was, club.
Yeah,
I
she,
met
him. Yeah, yeah. They were in a glass blowing class together on the fucking West Side.
Yeah, no question.
Of course. How, yeah, he went to a restaurant she was waiting tables at, and they fucking met.
Close,
right?
But no, I met him at a bar and restaurant in L.A. and I approached him.
You did.
Yeah.
How'd you approach Ooh. Him? What was your first line?
It's like
well,
Bumble.
I was waiting.
Suck it.
I was waiting for the bathroom, and I saw him, and I knew who he was, and we went to the same gym, and I was like, oh, my God, and then I went back to my table, and my best friend was like, that guy was staring at you. I was like, yeah, because I was staring at him. And she was like, no, he was like staring at you. Go talk to him.
Right.
And I was like, never. And then I was like, what do I care? I'm drunk. So I went and talked to him.
Right.
And then we, you know, went out for a while. And
why do I smell hot dogs right now? I don't know. Was it good?
Yes.
Awesome?
Yes.
Did you end it or did he? Him. I'll save it.
It was mutual.
Like it was mutual with him.
Mine was mutual.
His ex girl banging him right now.
It was geographically undesirable.
Yeah, exactly. Well, there you go. And it was worth it every second.
Every minute. It was the best day, the best night of my life.
It was one night. In a hotel.
The first time was.
It was in a hotel.
Yeah, it was in a hotel and an apartment.
Wow. And the same night was a hotel.
No,
and
it's not. No, I'm just saying, well, the last time was the best
night. Don't yell at me. Relax.
The best night of my life.
The last time was the best night. Yeah. Or the first time.
Both, but the last night, because I remember that one more.
Because you were sober.
No.
You weren't sober. You had to be drunk every time.
No, I'm not. No.
You're an alcoholic. You need help. What do you want to do? All right, listen, we're going to wrap this fucking show.
Yeah, I got a heart out, dog.
All right, so does anybody have any guesses in there?
Well, Don Swayze? I don't know who that is.
Excuse me?
Who's Don Swayze?
Patrick Swayze?
Patrick Swayze's son?
Jim Parsons, Bob Saget.
Bob Saget.
Jim Parsons. Okay, thank
you. All right, there we go.
Yeah. Yeah. What? Can they see me? I'm confused. I can do a little better than that. Bob Saget, Jim Parsons, Don Swayze. What the fuck are you talking about?
A little bit better. Yeah, you're right.
They kind of stopped guessing after you said you figured it out.
She's pretty hot. It does make sense, though, right? All right, sweetie, what do you got? Now that I know you, now that I know your real standards, I know that we're all out.
I'm going to be at the Stand tonight at 10 p.m. I'm going to be at the, where am I going to be? The Hartford Funny Bone on March 24th.
Are you headlining? Are you working with somebody?
With different people.
Who are you working with?
I'm working with, I don't know. I'm not at your level. Relax.
But no, that's what I'm saying. I'm trying to help you the whole show out, you fucking weirdo. What the fuck's wrong with you?
You insulted her a little bit. You got a little out of line yourself.
Yeah, really? I was just trying to say who the other comic was. I thought she was doing a show with somebody. That's all.
I'm just
quoting a movie.
Oh, all right. No, I was trying to. I didn't mean to make you. I wasn't trying to do that. I was just saying like who you're with. Oh, that's all, Bob. All right. So what's your Instagram? Your all that shit.
Everything. It's my name, which is really complicated. Luchana Gatica. At Luchana Gatica, everything.
That's a hard one.
LUCHANAGATICA. Or just look on this podcast Twitter.
Yeah, we got it up here. Yeah.
Might help if you change it to Air.
No, but he has a weird spelling, so.
Yeah, I had to ask him when we were walking in.
Yeah, that's what's stopping me from fucking you. The spelling of my name. Yeah. That's what's ruining it for me.
You should look into that.
Guys, heart out.
Yeah, well, you got, buddy, you got fucking 10 minutes.
No, 4 minutes.
I know.
4:50.
All right, what do you got, Joe?
March 16th, Helium in Philadelphia. I am headlining. It's a Wednesday.
Stop bragging.
I could use you come out here because, I'm not selling a lot of tickets. So if you come out Philly, I know we have a big fan base in Philly. It's a Wednesday night. I'll keep it quick. It'll be over early. You're going to get back to your kids.
How much time do you do when you headline?
I do 50.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Whatever. I suck today. This is today.
You were great today. Not funny, but very good. Solid. Not physically solid, but solid as like a performer.
Dude, I have a food headache. Can you hurry up?
I guess you could give that Mom Dana back to me. But I pressed the wrong button. Oh, March 11th and 12th, Long Island. I'm doing the Brokerage and the other one, McGuire's.
Brokerage
the
11th, clubs.
McGuire the 12th. Oh, they rock, baby.
James, fucking great guy.
Yes. And then
great family, great guy. Everybody in Long Island, go see Joe. Philadelphia, make sure you go check out Joe. Yeah. And make sure you check out my baby girl, Lucia.
What's her name?
You're really harassing her.
Am I really?
I don't like it.
No, he's not. He's jealous.
No.
Because he was in the head seat, but you like me more.
I just like you more. I have pictures of us naked on the beach together.
Well, give us a minute. We just met.
I hear you. I think Brendan is for you. He's married.
Dude, shut the fuck up. I'm getting a man shed with my own key.
bro, I got a heart out here. Bro.
How bad would it be if I fucking want to fucking jigs in a shed in my backyard? Well, my wife and kid were in the house. I was like, I gotta go write. I gotta go write and play drums.
She's like, how's your birdhouse coming? Your hair's all messed up. Your glasses are crooked.
Why do you smell like jizz?
Those birds really like the food. And then I have a podcast called Mondays with Memories. It's called Tuesdays with Stories, and it's really cooking. We got some hot, sexy guests coming up. And
I've never been on it.
No, and maybe I'll have you on after you pay me my T-shirt money. That might be fun.
I gotta get you that money. All right, please. What do you got, man?
Brendan.
I will be.
Brendan, I know. Brendan, what's up, buddy?
At
thanks for coming on, first of all.
Hey, thanks for having me, man.
Dude, really fucking funny.
Thanks for having me.
Great,
this is,
you know, both of you guys. Thanks for coming on. It was awesome.
Dude, this means a lot. Big fan, yeah. So I'm happy.
Definitely
to be here.
Come back on again. Definitely, all right? Yeah, absolutely.
Is that your way of trying to get my number?
No, I'm going to get that.
Too bad I got it. She's mine.
Hashtag shed.
Yeah, you have to fucking DM me that on the QT. Don't you know how to fucking cheat at all? You don't do it on the air, you fucking weirdo. Hashtag shed. Hashtag shed. DJ shed. Go ahead.
I will be.
My head shed. I got a fucking secret headroom. Go ahead, dude.
I'll be at Laugh Boston with
love that club.
I haven't been there yet. This is my first time.
You're gonna love it.
I'll be there with Colin Jost, March 18th.
See
and 19th.
How
I was just there.
Yeah, but do you this is the problem, you fucking insecure asshole. He was with. I was like, who are you there with? Like, the whole show, because you know what I mean. If you're there with somebody,
yeah.
I wasn't trying to like. I you know. I'm not.
I know,
don't
I'm
worry.
Just kidding.
I know, but I'm sorry.
And then, yeah, get in
listen,
there.
No, I'm kidding. I'm sorry, I love you, dude. You'll be back on way more than her. I'm kidding. Jesus Christ,
we're
Joe, help
deal.
Me.
I've been eating my name for him. We're a package deal.
Go ahead.
And then I will be on Adam Devine's house party on Comedy Central March 31st.
The fuck is that?
It's like their new low level.
What is that?
It's their like new intro level cool. stand up show.
Yeah. Why are you applauding it?
It's a big deal for him. He's getting on TV, and I'm happy for him.
That's my first TV thing. Yeah.
Right, well, don't let us all applaud. Don't make us look bad by your fucking applauding.
You're right. I should have applauded the Funny Bone plug as well. Dog.
Can I plug Sarah's?
I wish you had a Funny
Bone.
Bye,
Joe.
Bob, can I plug Sarah's TV thing? April 6th.
Of course you can.
My birthday.
Yes,
plug Sarah.
A little
bit more important, I would say. But
yes, her TV thing is way more important than you.
Adam Devine's house party, April
6th. Oh, he was
the
just talking
yours.
About that.
That's
yeah,
why
yeah.
I heard it, and I thought, you know.
It was done in Hawaii,
yeah,
correct?
Yeah, me and Joe had a rousing tennis match.
We played tennis.
In Hawaii.
So cute.
Like real whites.
Yeah. Way to end the show on a fucking lull. That was fucking with you. Hard out, remember? Make it harder. Make it quicker, too. Listen, hey, so yeah, dude, thanks for coming on, and we'll
thanks
definitely check out
man.
Your show. And Laugh Boston, you're gonna love that show. And the Funny Bone is I love that club too. The people there, when I first went there, I was like, fuck this place. But then I the manager there, if it's the same manager, she's really cool. The sound guy, what?
It's not.
What is?
It's not the same manager.
Oh,
she's,
it's not?
She's
gone?
She's gone, yeah.
What, who's there now?
The guy, her assistant.
Oh, the black dude?
Yeah.
Oh, he's the manager.
Yeah.
That's why I haven't been back. you know what this fucking guy used to do when you were on stage and you were going over? Like, if you're doing over an hour, he would turn the lights on the stage up to make it hot.
Oh.
Great.
I had to literally from stage go, if you don't turn the lights off, lower the lights, I'm going to hit you with this fucking mic stand in the middle of my set. And people were like, what? I was like, I'm looking right through the little peek hole,
yeah.
And I'm like, you, I'm gonna fucking smash, cause he was toasting me like a fucking a suckling pig. But I actually grew to like him a lot. He was actually nice to me, the few other times that I went there. So actually a good club. So dude, what do you got, sweetie? What do we got?
You're gonna be on April 23rd at the Renaissance Theater in Kingsport. Tennessee.
Oh, this is a big Dr. Steve put this together. Jim Florentine did it last year, and it's a big show that he put together that I'm actually flying down to do. I'm very excited about it. I love Tennessee. The one and only time I played there, which I was very excited about going there, was at the Side Splitters. It was the wild, wild west.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, I got a video of a lady just coming out and fucking smashing a beer on the ground. Oh, God. I remember a lady was just talking in the front row, and I fucking had her kicked out. the middler was just going up doing fucking redneck shit, just this fat redneck blonde kid that won best comic in the woods or whatever the fuck he won. And then literally, you just hold up a T-shirt at the end. And just, you know, fuck, my T-shirt gonna be outside. You gonna get fucking, you know, fucking big wheels for fucking cheers, whatever the fuck it was. And sucked. And then the lady kicked out, and then comes back in 20 minutes later. I'm from Hawaii.
Oh my God.
And I went, I don't even know what the fuck that means. Literally, she came back in, fought her way back into the room, to say I'm from Hawaii. I hope she's dead. I do. I hope they all died. Literally. I hope a truck lost its brakes at a red light and ran over your fucking Subaru. But I'm going back. A lot of the fans there were great. So I'm excited to go back, and Dr. Steve's putting that on. What else do I got? Nice. I got one on the 26th, too. I don't know if it's public yet. With Luis Gomez, March 26th, I believe it is, Saturday night. And I'm also, go ahead, the podcast. Talk about that.
Yeah, so we're going to be doing a Pod Fest on May 22nd. It's a Sunday. I posted everything on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, so you guys can go and check it out. We're going to be there. We have a 9:30 p.m. slot. It's going to be going on for an hour, so you can buy your tickets. The link and everything's up now. So it's or you can check out PodFest New York.
Yeah, check out that. We're going to be selling that out, so it's going to be a small room. So get your tickets now. Spread the word. Retweet it. Share it. Do all that shit you guys do to help us spread the word about that. What's the date on that again?
It's May 22nd. It's a Sunday.
May 22nd, Sunday. What else we got?
If you want to send anything in.
Oh, I forgot. Yeah. Real quick. I forgot to tell everybody. Yeah.
What?
I'm so tired. I forgot to tell. Chris Scopo's not here. I didn't even fucking acknowledge.
Aw, Scopes.
You know what? Fuck both of you. Literally. Nothing bothers me more than fucking women going,
oh. Well, sorry, we have emotions.
It's not it's fake emotions. Yeah. That's why it bugs me.
No.
No, it is, because if you gave a fuck, either one of you would have, especially you, would have been like, "Where's? Why don't you say why Chris isn't here?" You would be fucking.
No.
First of all, you are basically taking his job. Okay. No. You slowly fucking. I'm not gonna need him anymore, and you're taking his job. You learned all the jobs. It's just gonna be you. So fuck Chris and you.
I didn't like that you forgot him, that's all, because that's how I got here, so.
You're not here because of him. You're here because of me.
I know, but he's the one, he was the middleman.
No, he's not. I said, you get somebody, I would bang. And he got him. And then No, Chris hurt his back, so I hope he feels better.
Yeah.
He's probably listening to this right now at his mother's house eating pasta she made. You're going to be all right, Chrissy. I know, Ma. I know. I just, you know, I got to stop doing deadlifts. You know, my ass is my closer. I have to fucking boo. I hope you feel better, you fuckface. And he'll be back next week, hopefully. What else? What else?
So if you want to send anything to the studio.
Yeah, all this stuff behind me is sent in from fans. All this shit. We got stickers coming. I'm ordering them today or tomorrow. So we're going to be giving stickers out to fans who come in. You want to come into the studio. You want to mail us something. Give the address out.
It's 117 McDougal Street, New York, New York, 10012. And just put attention YKWD Podcast or Robert Kelly.
All this stuff is from fans. You want to send me cigars or whatever. I want to thank the guys at Cigar Fly. I try not to burp into the mic. Mm-hmm. Someone actually gave me
someone
shit.
Someone said
that was going
to
be.
Sorry, I had to do it.
Just do it.
I did it. Fuck them. Okay. It's my podcast.
It's your podcast.
I love both of you now. Oh, fuck. I don't want to do. I'm not having any more guys on the show. Just women.
Let's do another tampon episode.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I love it. All men talk about is their dicks and shitting. And women come on. Pussies, blood, pussy, blood. Guys are assholes. all this shit is from fans. And Cigar Fly, you guys are great. Thank you so much. Tatooine and My Father Cigars. Those guys hooked me up with a bunch of shit too, mm-hmm. and I love it. So if,
Vader.
Vader, fucking Christ! Mm-hmm. Chad over at Vader, the guy at Sabian sent me fucking symbols. I can't thank him enough. Chris and I can't believe it. Mm-hmm. I got a lot of great stuff. So and Dark Horse Drums contacted me too.
Oh, nice.
The fucking drum company for 20 years, custom drums out of Jersey. So if you check them out, darkhorse.com, unbelievable drums. Mm-hmm. They custom make drums for people for the last 20 years, which I love. Small businesses. I might be getting a drum kit from them. We'll see. What else the fuck do I got?
Yeah, well, if you want to come to the studio, just email producer@ryecast.com, and we'll do it that way. And then make sure you subscribe and like our YouTube channel, Twitter, Instagram, everything.
Yeah, and if you have any dick pics at all, please send them to Lauren.
I'll rate them.
At
Lauren Kubera on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah, but send them to YK. Please send them to me because she'll delete them. We'll never see them.
I'll save them.
Send them to dude@riotcast.com. Okay? That's my email. Is that my email? Yeah, dude@riotcast.com. Send us dick pics for. Now, don't fucking, make sure it's a good shot. I don't want to see little puds.
Will you copy me on those?
Yeah,
I'll copy you. Thank you. I'll filter out the bad ones.
Yeah, get them from her, because somehow you'll fucking sue me. You have weird fucking, I'm going to stick famous guy jizz in my fucking pussy from a barrel. Send us dick pics if you got them. And if you want to send pussy pics, send them to Lauren, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll take those.
Yeah, they'll make them to you. Are you out of your mind? Fucking. That's the one thing. When was the last? Did any girl ever send you tit pics or dirty pics?
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Really now?
Yeah, a little
off
bit.
Off of what?
I have this girl who heard me on a podcast and she sent me. She started Snapchatting me naked pictures of herself. Right?
Okay.
And
those go away.
And I'm you can screenshot it.
But they know you screenshot.
But I said I'm gonna screenshot it.
All right. Well, I'm sorry. Again. I told you I'm gonna be a private eye.
Yeah.
That's why I had to go to the end of that.
So I get guilty because she's 19, right? So
oh,
I
God.
Go.
Oh,
so I go. You can't send me these. And then the next time I'm in a hotel on the road, I go. You know how I said you can't send me those? Hey, you probably could send. Like you could send me some if you want. And so I got that going. It's pretty good.
What you're fucking. Fucking creepness.
Ew. Yeah. Just a creepy. this story I thought would be better than it is.
Way to close the show. Go see him at Laugh Boston. Wow. All right, we're gonna fucking. What else do we got? Anything else?
That's it. Yep. Podfest 2016.
That's all we got. Depot. Anything?
No, she mentioned the YouTube page, right? Check out the YouTube page.
There you go. Awesome. You did? You didn't mention the YouTube page.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, she did.
Yeah, make sure you subscribe to that, right? It's been going fucking nuts.
Yeah, we're getting a lot of comments, a lot of discussion each week. It's it's growing.
Yeah,
so that's great.
Yeah, man, you guys are fucking great. All the fans checking that out, and the people who hate it, too. I hope you die and get fucking hit by a deer. I really do. I hope you're on the fucking highway, and a deer just runs in front of your car, and a horn goes through your fucking temple, and you can just hate our show in silence because you can't talk because you're in a wheelchair going, and my wife, what, you okay? And she's, oh, I'll play your favorite podcast. Do you know what? You know what? And you're like, eh. And she thinks, means you enjoy it. Like, oh, he really likes it. Every time I play this podcast, he moves. But you're really trying to just fucking shut off the fucking phone with your head. And you can't do it.
You've been listening to the YKWD podcast. Thanks for listening. Now go back to your shitty jobs.
Shitty jobs. Shitty jobs.
Check out riotcast.com for all of the best podcasts on the internet. And they are all free.
And they are all free.